I go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the trash, man it's so tough.
Alright yo, put the belly on the bay, make a catch. Seen her watch, now she wanna give. Boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod. Man a real life sugar gal, I might forget what. When she want dark, so they meet me at the top. So she love her other day, I seen her waiting for a bus.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to Brave New Voices Final Stage. Make some noise. Hit the comments. Let us know if you're feeling good. Hit the chat. Make sure y'all telling us y'all feeling good. Everybody at home, thank y'all so much. We are at day 6 of the Brave New Voices Festival. Wow. Thank y'all so much for rocking with us all week long. It ain't over with. We are here for this moment. Poets from around the world have been spitting their truth and getting free all week. And we are down to our final 4 competing teams. We are so excited for y'all. Thank y'all so, so much. My name is Darius Parker, BKA Halle Berry Berry Skirt. I serve as your co-festival director alongside the amazing Sydney Edwards, which you'll hear from in a moment. We just want to say collectively that we have put our heart and soul into this festival, and we hope that it was everything that you could have imagined it to be. Thank you so, so much for holding space with us all week, from interpreter to closed captioner to participant to production to partner to everybody to have something to do with this festival. We thank you. Also remembering that this festival is a part of a virtual action, This Is How I Breathe, taking over all the social media platforms. For those of you who have engaged and those of you who have not, it's not too late. Thank you so, so much for holding the space from our deepest parts of our full hearts. Thank you so, so much. And before we jump into everything, I'm gonna kick it to a youth poet coming from Chicago, Illinois, my home, from Kumba Links, my home organization, which I currently am a part of, Mr. Askia Bully. Askia, bring it home for us. Shout out to Chicago. Shout out to Kumba Links, Ashe.
Hello, everyone. I'm Askia Bully. And I wanted to leave you guys with this note today. And I'll start it. Today and every day, we must do a better job to hold each other. Liberation begins with acknowledging our historical truth. The truth about chattel slavery and genocide, the peoples who endured the atrocities, our ancestors. Let's recognize the presence of folks indigenous to the places where we live by calling out and dropping them in the chat. Perhaps you don't know, we'll find out. Make the time for it. Let's do this work and bloom our world beautiful. It is our duty to remain grateful for the original peoples who laid the foundation for the places we may now call our hoods. We must honor these ancestors as well as the diverse indigenous nations that reside on these lands today. Here in Chicago, Kumba Links acknowledges that we reside within the traditional homelands of many indigenous Native American nations, including the Oto tribe, Winnebago, Missouria, Iowas, Menominee, Meskwaki, Sauk, Miami, Wee, Kickapoo, Anoka, Odawa, and Potawatomi tribes. Thank you.
Thank you so, so much, Ski. Can't wait to see you soon, man. Hope you're taking care. Peace out, peace out. Thank you so much for sharing that. Thank y'all so much for joining us. I know I keep thanking y'all, but I have to let y'all know how grateful that we damn are that we're able to gather virtually. To everybody at home, what's up? Turn up in the comments, turn up in the chat. We're gonna have us a great time. So, in truest Brave New Voices fashion, Darius has the esteemed privilege, shout out to Future Core. I have the esteemed privilege to introduce the amazing, the dazzling, the phenomenal, my co-festival director and longtime friend, Miss Sydney Edwards, y'all. Make some noise. Thank Hit the you, comments. Woo! Woo! A beauty.
Hello, 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 everyone. Thank you so much, Darius. You're so cute with your esteemed privilege, y'all. He loves a privilege. Not a privilege, but he loves to have the esteemed privilege of announcing somebody. I love it. I just want to just bask in the beauty that is all of y'all real quick. And thank you for tuning in to the Grand Slam Finals. Y'all, we've curated an amazing night. Your judges are dope, but hold on. What you need to know is that these youth poets are absolutely flame, fuego. I'm so excited for you all to see these poems. So we're going to forget about the scores and all that mushy stuff, but there's someone who I'm so excited to introduce you all to. And hopefully it's not the first time you've heard his name or saw his face. Your MC for this evening, and I gotta give him his flowers and read his bio, y'all. Marc Bamuthi Joseph, your MC for the evening, is a 2017 TED Global Fellow, an inaugural recipient of the Guggenheim Social Practice Initiative, and an honoree of the United States Artist Rockefeller Fellowship. Okay, while engaging in a deeply fulfilling and successful artistic career, Bamuthi also proudly serves as the Vice President and Artistic Director of Social Impact at the John F. Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts in Washington, D.C.
Let's go.
He is in high demand for his creative approach to organizational design, brand development, and community mediation, and has been enlisted as a strategic partner, y'all, or a consultant for companies ranging from Coca-Cola to the Carnegie Hall. He is the founding program director of the exemplary nonprofit Youth Speaks that brought us all here today, and he is a co-founder of Life is Living, a national series of one-day festivals which activate under-resourced parks and affirm peace for urban life. His essays have been published in the Harvard Education Press, and he's lectured at more than 200 colleges. But more important than all of this, he is a truly amazing, humble, electric, exciting human being who is going to show love to all of these youth poets and bring you the best slam you've ever seen. With no more hesitation, I bring you Marc Bamuthi Joseph, y'all.
What up, brave new voices, let's go, I'm super amped, broadcasting live from DC, Sydney, I now want to marry you where you at, damn, it's amazing, thank you for all that love and all that affirmation, I cannot believe that here we are through it all, it's extraordinary. I have to tell you that as we are in a moment of concurrent crises, a few months ago, when we thought that Brave New Voices was gonna happen at my institutional home, the Kennedy Center in DC, as the pandemic swept across this country and across this planet, I was like, man, I don't think we can do Brave New Voices this year. Made no sense to me at all. But because of folks like Darius, because of folks like Sid, because of Brittany, because of Josh, because of the Queen Joan Osado, because of the entire team that has worked tirelessly to organize this moment for the collective and for the family, we are back at it. And I just cannot express my love enough. Thank you to the organizers, but thank you to the poets for showing up, for believing in yourself, for honoring your word. Darius asked me if that is the Holy Beyonce, and it is. My patron saints are with us. Uncle James and Auntie B are both here in the house. I got the shit smelling like Love Jones up in here, all kinds of like vanilla and jasmine and lavender and shit, because I'm that mother. So yes, it is a full-on poetry reading. We have incredible judges, we have an incredible host, and incredibly, we have you. So I'm going to turn it right back to my incredibly lovely co-host, Sid, so that maybe you can introduce the judges to the assembled family. And Darius, you are not stealing my candle.
You better watch him because he does steal.
Okay.
I put this crown down and then I found it on his head. So be careful.
Do that. Y'all not gonna do that to the girl.
He will be at your door in just a moment. Be careful. But like Bamuthi said, it is my pleasure now to introduce you all to the judges. So this is a poetry slam. We do have some very fine folks who are gonna assign some silly scores to some really great poems. So I want y'all to meet them, rather. I know them, I like them a whole lot, and I hope you will too. So first off, you will meet Sonya Renee Taylor, who is an artist, an author, an activist, and transformational leader. She is a national and international award-winning writer, performer, published author, and the founder and radical executive officer of The Body Is Not an Apology. Y'all need to check it out. It's not a game. An international digital media and educational company committed to radical self-love and body empowerment as the foundational tool of social justice, whose content reaches over 1 million people every month. She shared her work in activism across the United States, New Zealand, Australia, UK, Scotland, Sweden, Germany, Canada, Brazil, the Netherlands. Sonya has been seen and heard on HBO, BET, MTV, VH1, NPR, PBS, CEN, let's get it. The list goes on and on. She was a guest of the Obama White House where she spoke about TBINAA's work in the intersection of the LGBTQIAA+ issues and disability justice. She currently resides in California and New Zealand sometimes, where she's an inaugural fellow of the Edmund Hillary Fellowship. Y'all, give it up for Miss Sonya Renee Taylor, who will be judging today, y'all.
Hooray, you better know that.
Better know. Our next judge that you'll hear from is the amazing Maida Del Valle. A poet and performer, Maida Del Valle has been described by the Chicago Sun-Times, I love this quote, having a way with words, sometimes they seem to flutter and roll off her lips, other times they burst forth like a comet streaking across a nighttime sky. Come on, sometimes, Chicago. A proud native of the South Side of Chicago, Maida got her start at the New York City's legendary New Yorican Poets Cafe, where she was the 2001 Grand Slam champion, went on to win the 2001 National Poetry Slam individual title. Y'all noticed that was the same year, right? Okay, just checking. She went on to appear on 6 episodes of Russell Simmons' Deaf Poetry Jam. She's been featured in Latina Magazine, The Source, The New York Times, and was named by the Smithsonian, our partners at this festival, as one of America's young innovators in the arts and sciences. She was also Oprah's O Magazine, one of the 20 women for their first ever O Power List. And since 2011, Maida has been a teaching artist with the poetry-based nonprofit youth organization, Street Poets. She is a dancer, a vocalist with the Los Angeles-based Afro-Puerto Rican Bomba group, Atabe, and is currently pursuing an MFA in creative writing at California Institute of the Arts and currently resides in Chicago. Please show love to the beautiful Maida Del Valle. I love it. I see the chat blowing up, please. Judges, look at the chat blowing up for y'all. Next up is Julian Randall, y'all. Julian Randall is a living queer Black poet from Chicago, a recipient of multiple fellowships. Julian is the recipient of the Pushcart Prize. He also holds an MFA in poetry from Ole Miss. Okay, y'all see him. He is also the author of Refuse, which won the Cave Canem Poetry Prize and was a finalist for the NAACP Image Award. Do y'all understand? The middle grade novel Pilar Ramirez and The Prison of Zafa. He can be found at Julian the Poet and on his website, juliandavidrandall.com. Check him out and show love for Julian Randall, y'all. We gotta give them their flowers. These judges are not playing. They are almost as cool as the poets. I live. Okay, next up, we got Keith David, y'all. Keith David. Why does my document want to play me? Just kidding. Next up we have, why is it playing? I'm going to say it from the heart because this app is tripping, but we got to move on. Keith David, y'all, is my granddaddy in my mind and in my soul. An amazing actor and mentor, an amazing member of just the Black community. This person is a member of Oprah's own circle, featured on her network. Y'all may have seen the show. It's something called Greenleaf. He plays the pastor, AKA Bishop, and is truly just a tremendous person. I've got to meet him along this process by way of my co-festival director, and he is truly a phenomenal force, from just talking about Black studies to contemporary issues and what we need to do as artists to use our voices and our platforms. This man is about who he is about. He is even more amazing than the person you see on TV. Make some noise, y'all, for Keith David.
Hurry.
I live. When they said Pastor Greenleaf was gonna join us, y'all, I almost cried. I did a little dance. Thank you so much for being with us, Keith David. And last but not least, our five judges is Jasmine Manns. She is an author with the Berkeley Penguin Random House. She's also was a Future of Storytelling Fellow. Her visual artwork has been featured in gallery exhibits. She was a graduate of the University of Wisconsin-Madison First Wave program. Her songwriting has supported artists like Kelly Rowland and John Bellion. She is the creative director of Bi-Weed from Women. She has also curated and ideated artist-based initiatives for the Newark Public School District. She is alum of Brave New Voices, not only as a poet, but also as a coach. She is the City of Newark and Mayor Ross Baraka and the Newark Public Library, has contributed work in archives like the Schomburg Center for Research in Black Culture, the Free Black Women's Library, the Benek Rare Book and Manuscript Library at Yale, and the list goes on and on. Please show love for the incomparable Jasmine Manns, y'all.
Yes.
So shout out to those judges. We love y'all and we're so happy. We're scared that you have to score these great, great, great poems. But I do have a treat. Right now, we'll be bringing one of them judges on back as a feature. The first poem you'll hear tonight will be from Jasmine Manns. Please give it up. Make the chat go crazy.
How do you tell a woman that raising a Black son isn't some type of inside joke crafted by God and some white man? Can you prove to me that they are not in heaven snickering at the soul of a single parent mother dressing her son up for graduation, hoping he can make it across the stage, down the aisle or off the balcony quick enough to not get caught in his skin at the wrong time? I've touched the bellies of mothers who aborted Black boys like thrown overboard slaves, who will look you in the eyes like a bluebird awakening to a Holocaust and whisper, I'm just afraid to raise a Black son. A Black boy is just a trembling soul suffocating in a fabric that always seemed to make you scratch around your neck, the tag that always seemed to make you itch around your noose collar. How can you tell a mother holding her son in a delivery room, praying that his skin doesn't get any darker, hoping that it stays as light and deceiving as a sunrise in the ghetto, that her son isn't some white man's pit stop, that her son's body isn't a chamber for some bigot to store his sin and Southern accent in, that her son isn't some colored toy for the rich blue-eyed boys? I'm just afraid to raise a Black son who will spend the rest of his life praying for a melody or a melanin safe enough to scream in. A son who has to be a martyr for a war that he ain't ever asked for. You look hungry. Like that girl don't make you no fried chicken or macaroni and cheese. Like she don't feel you on the inside. Like you haven't had a home-cooked meal since your mama died. You look like you lost the psalm in your own song. Like you want to talk to God, but you're afraid because y'all ain't spoken so long. You tell your daughter about me, how we were bittersweet, to never mess with entertainers because they always leave, that he'll get on and he'll leave your ass for a white girl and he'll give her your style, your language, your waist, damn near try to give her your face, and somewhere in his post-traumatic twisted fantasy, he'll make it all okay. But what's the worth in loving a man who's lost his smile anyway? When Kim fucks up the lyrics to the College Dropout like them white folk used to fuck up your name, do you pretend not to notice? Do you regret the Marilyn Monroe and your decision and wish you could have taken Billie Holiday as your bride? Do you ever want to run back to your wedding day and have it all over on the South Side? Do you wake up in the middle of the night and just think that she wasn't the right girl? Like maybe you should have found one of them I like art type girls. Can you hear all the black kids calling your name? Wondering why the boy who rapped about his mama getting arrested for the sit-ins didn't sit in. Why he traded in his Nat Turner for Ralph Lauren. Do you know how many kids at the protest had your sneakers on? None of them. Do you know how many of your songs were played at the protest? All of them. Could you hear all of the lights, the flashing lights, the new slaves, the runaways on their road to redemption, waiting for Kanye West to have the whole world at attention? Nigga, they got you quiet. Like, how come only at award shows he riots? Maybe Jesus was all talk. Jesus never needed Adidas to walk. Why is he outlining sneakers when the South Side is outlined in chalk? Can someone go and find the man who can make a diamond? With his own bare hands, we are looking for you. Because these kids don't want to be just like you. They want to rap and make soul beats just like you. Even though you just not you. Even though you traded in your spaceship to buy back your 40 acres and a mule, purchase the plantation and master's daughters too. Nigga, why you got these white folks claiming you? Like they built you, like they made you, like they polished you, like they readied them a good nigga for the picking, like they got you for sale. Oh, how they love Kanye. Let's put them all in front of the store. Like you there, black boy. You forgot you, black boy. They got you lost in this world. You getting blackmailed for that white girl. You don't see how your lies is affecting me. You don't see how our lives were supposed to be. And I never let a nigga get that close to me. And you ain't cracked up to what you were supposed to be. I guess it's bittersweet poetry.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, Jasmine, y'all. That's my soul roar for that amazing piece. Thank you so, so, so much. You know I had to say it, Bamuthi. You know I had to shout that out.
Yes.
Real quick, I just want to tell you a little bit about the job of the judges, and then you'll hear all about what we're about to get into. The judges will score the poems that you hear tonight. We will be announcing the score, so you will hear them from me directly after the poem to which they pertain, but those scores don't matter. All that matters is the poems, so y'all just show love to the poets. Back over to you, Bamuthi. Let's get it started.
All right, let's get it started. So, judges, here's the spiel. Your job is to judge these poets according to your own opinions. Trust your self-score consistently. My peoples across screens, across this whole planet, your job is to listen, respond, show love to these poets. You can do this by showing love in the chat or by doing hand motions when you're on mute. Poets, your job is to be honest and to move from your heart. This is not about the numbers. It's about speaking truth to power, sharing our stories, helping each other along the way. Poets, you are now on team. Clap for everybody. Yes? Some things. Content warnings. Before we go any further, I would like to let you know that this event is free of censorship. You may hear poems that inspire you or allow you to see the world in new ways. You may also hear poems that are graphic, covering issues such as racism, mental health, trauma, sexuality, self-harm, abuse, and more. I strongly encourage you, if you are feeling triggered by any part of this event, to do what you need to do in order to keep yourself healthy and safe. For clarity, triggers are things that cause a person to relive trauma in their mind and body. We encourage you to assess your own needs and remember that there is a difference between feeling uncomfortable and feeling unsafe in this space. Yes? Yes? Sweet. With that said, I hope y'all are ready for the slam. These incredible teams, these incredible poets, today represent four cities across North America. We are going to hear from poets from St. Louis, Missouri. We are going to hear from poets from Miami Gardens, Florida. We are going to hear from poets representing Fayetteville, North Carolina, Kakalaka in the house. And we are going to hear from poets representing Los Angeles, California. We in the South. We in the Midwest. We West Coast. I'm from New York, representing the Northeast. Yo, we all over the place. We all over the map, but we are concentrated live in this moment in the name of exemplary word and profound youth leadership. Congratulations to all. In order to make this thing go right, and in order to make sure that the judges, who are all exceptional in their own right, kind of know what the fuck they doing before we go further in, we are going to have a calibration poet. Go in, poet. I, as your MC, have the great honor of welcoming our calibration poet. This is Abuja stepping to the microphone.
What the fuck, though? Where the love go? 5, 4, 3, 2, I let one go. Wow, get the fuck, though.
Let's go, Dion.
Aiming at your head like a buffalo. You a roughneck, I'm a cutthroat. You a tough guy, that's enough jokes. Then the sun died, the night is young though. The diamond still shine.
This is how I breathe. Brown skin girl, your skin just like pearls. You didn't know that, did you? It took a world-known singer for you to realize that you are special. Wasn't this something they thought essential in all your home training while they were raising you to be the perfect maiden? Didn't they think that you should learn how to love yourself, to value your mental health? Or maybe they thought you'd pick it up along the way like a book from a shelf and it will be ingrained in your brain just like being tough is. Like how you already know not to walk down the streets at night because yours is a freshly picked apple ready to tempt every atom out on them streets. They don't care if you're Eve, your body is a forbidden fruit and they want it. Beats having daddy issues though. Don't we all have daddy issues? Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot that I am just a black girl whose father is probably dead, arrested, or is cousins with the wind and plays Houdini. Isn't that what you were thinking? A black girl survives without her daddy. A black girl needs nobody because brown skin girls are tough. Daniel Blinky didn't understand that I wasn't tough. And I didn't want to be touched, that my poetry was screaming out words that my PTSD mouth couldn't. It was saying, love me. Please, love me. Not my body, love me. Or leave me alone. But black girls aren't meant to be loved. No, black girls don't cry out their eyes in the dark of night. They don't understand trauma. They can't knife open their skin for answers. They know better. See, suicide is not a black people thing. Not a Nigerian thing. It's not African enough. Not cultural enough. Not ethnic enough. But it does exist enough. Now, brown skinned girl, I know. I know nobody expects you to have issues with your head because you tough. I know nobody expects you to have issues with your body, shawty, you a queen. I know nobody expects you to have anxiety. So wrap up all your insecurities in a ball. Keep it in the goalpost of your heart under lock and key until all they see is strong. Because brown skin girls have black girl magic, so they are immune to pain. How can we be immune to the one thing that we know better than ourselves? Thank you, Beyonce. But brown skin girl, you're not just special because someone wrote a song about you. You do have black girl magic. You are strong, and even the days when you are weak cannot change this. It is scripture written into the Bible of your body. Your body, the temple of God. Your body, the temple of greatness and all things beautiful. It is okay to be afraid, but it is not okay to die in silence. Too many of your brothers have. Brown skin girl, fight.
Yes, 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 yes. Go in, poet. How magical, how scriptural, how prayerful. Thank you so much. And shout out to my very good friend, our DJ for the finals tonight, who didn't get enough love, Dion Decibels, on the ones and twos, always delivering. Yer, I see you. Make America Mexico again. Hey, co-host Sydney.
Hey.
How you doing over there?
I'm doing great. Our judges are really loving the piece, and I think it just took them some time. It's feeling in their soul. That's what's happening. That's what's happening. But as soon as I get some scores, we gonna hear them. But shout out to Abuja.
Yeah, man. Exceptional. And I have to say, I love what we're doing just production-wise. All over the country, the way that we've taken creativity and originality to the next level in terms of performing these works right where we are. You know what I mean?
Definitely.
That's exactly how we get free.
For sure, for sure. So I do have some scores from low to high. For that poem from Abuja, we got a 7.9, a 7.9, an 8, an 8.2, and an 8.5, but forget about the scores. Everybody make noise for that poet.
Buckle. Sweet, the judges is just starting with the sharp edges. I get it. You know what I mean? But I can honestly say that this group of judges, I don't know how we got so lucky to find these folks, to find these five folks. But one thing I cannot clown is the authority of these judges. So we're gonna put our trust in y'all, but we're gonna put our love into these poets. Round one, we are going to experience these poets in this order. Last, we're gonna hear from Los Angeles. Third, we're gonna hear from Fayetteville. Second, we're gonna hear from Miami. And first, we're going to hear from St. Louis. So St. Louis, Miami, Fayetteville, Los Angeles. That being said, Miami Gardens, y'all are on deck. But brave new voices, please do the Cabbage Patch, do the Running Man, do an old school dance for my peoples from St. Louis, Missouri. Please welcome the team from St. Louis up to the
Millie and Christine McCoy, two women strung together, their spines stitched together, created a blended quilt of their bodies, Millie and Christine. Siamese, conjoined twins born in 1851, died in 1912. I am the direct descendant of a tree whose roots were twisted together in agony, kidnapped and stolen from their family. They were sold into the circus. At 10 months old, instead of being displayed for their adorable manner, they were deemed freaks of nature. They mastered the art of trapeze, learned to use their voices to swing between enslavement and employment, called the eighth wonder of the world, screwed eight times over slave, Siamese, specimens, curiosities, cretins, creatures, and black, and female, and freak, fearfully and wonderfully made. The world couldn't fathom their excellence, so they exploited it. Paraded around a freak show, getting tangled in the tightrope more chains. Their freedom was a business transaction. So Purvis sold to Bauer and Bauer sold to Smith. They ended up a product of Barnum, who would go on to be praised as a hero in 2017. The Greatest Showman got famous for that song, "This Is Me." I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies. So this is me, the living blood of Millie and Christine, the descendant whose mouth was roped shut, strung up my ancestors like marionette dolls, stuffed my mouth with cotton like they picked, prevented me from telling their story by cutting off any recollection that might form a coherent connection between them and I. Conjoined twins severed from my memory, erased from your textbooks, unless you're referring to racial slurs. For once, I don't mean the word nigger. Siamese is the only bridge between them and I, and if they weren't a product or a puppet, even their names would remain a foreign taste on my bleached tongue. Millie and Christine are more than a story to be brushed past, more than a song that dances over the cruelty of Barnum, but women. One woman with two voices singing one song of togetherness and isolation, of triumph and strength, in the five languages they were fluent in. They left field songs to sing for Queen Victoria, exchanged chains for diamond embellished bracelets, turned impediments into assets. Even in death, they demonstrated strength. Millie died 12 hours before her sister Christine. She carried the both of them around for half a day. But even with all of their fame, tell me why they were buried in an unmarked grave. Why must my ancestors remain a mystery? Why, even after hearing this poem, will you forget them? Why did I have to learn about them from Google searches and white authors? Because stories like theirs are always being pushed on the back burner, being engulfed in flames before ever seeing the light of day. But I will be the voice for the voiceless and utter their story until my breath runs out, because I refuse to let another story of Black women fade into oblivion like it always seems to happen now, because it happened to them and this poem is resurrecting them. May they never be left dead again. I am them and they are me. So I will scream their names until it rings in my ears and fails to leave your memory, Millie and Christine.
Wow. Off top. Wow. Brave new voices. St. Louis just stepped in the building and wrecked shop off top. Wow. Amazing work. Amazing work. Wherever you happen to be, if you're in your cars, if you're in your kitchen, if you're in the bathroom, if you're in the park, wherever you are, please kiss one up to the poet from St. Louis that just offered incredible word. You know, I have to say, when we were in the poets huddle before the slam began, one of the things that we did was we talked about where our mothers are from. We talked about the journeys that our families have endured in order to bring us to this moment. And I can't think of a better way to start this poem than with the invocation of those that came before directly in our lineage. You paid homage beautifully, poet. Thank you so much. Hey, Sydney, what we got?
What's good? From that poet for St. Louis, from low to high, we have an 8.1, an 8.4, an 8.8, a 9, and another 9. But give it up for that poet.
Woo, give it up for the poet. Give it up for the poet. We're going to keep it moving. Fayetteville, North Carolina, you are on deck right now. Please, brave new voices, bring your energy in and up for the poet from Miami Gardens. Y'all give it up for Miami Gardens.
Rubia no me entiende si yo le hablo en español, pero se aprendió la canción a la perfección. Por mi patria, por mi nación, ninguna discriminación. Aquí no hay raza ni religión, bailalo por obligación.
Before completing the following steps, please be sure to separate your colored clothes from your whites. Choose your load size, super load. Choose your water temperature, hot. Your colored clothes will bleed. Now, pick your time, 60 minutes. Press start. Allow your water to fill to its maximum level. Insert detergent of your preference. Allow time for dilution. Then, when you're ready, toss your colored clothes in for a wash. After the cycle, if your clothes are not as clean as you would like them to be, please feel free to rinse and repeat. The incarceration system is a washing machine, drowning out little Black boys and girls with time. Living in a world where we only gain strikes and stripes, we gotta hand wash our jumpsuits, scrub the bloodstains out from around the bullet holes. The system chews us up and spits us out only to suck us back in again. The worst form of regurgitation, rinse, repeat. and believed to be even a little dirty. Black kids get thrown into the system, their brains get washed into thinking that their mistakes are unremovable stains. They call us colored convicts, rinse and repeat. Prisons are packed like a superload, an overflow of what has been mistaken for dirty clothes. This is not a life you choose, but a life that was chosen for kids who have no control over the color of their skin. Orange, bending new black, covering up melanin with hand-me-down black and white bars, just for these chocolate bars to sit behind bars. Bunks are packed like the Middle Passage. And if these pupils aren't passing, the school passes them through the school-to-prison pipeline, rinse and repeat. Even bleach stains colors? Let's probate. Limiting their freedom in the land of the free, probation leads colors right back to incarceration. They have to get a job but can't because of their lack of education, setting them up for violation, rinse and repeat. Colors become faded the way they're being worn out. They don't crack whips anymore. They crack cases on crack cases, rinse and repeat while we wrestle for rights, right? Wrong. Republicans raise their riches and reject the reality that they bring our necks like towels. The 13th Amendment was supposed to abolish slavery, not dress it up and call it a penitentiary. Mass incarceration is the modern day Jim Crow, and colors keep falling victim to the system, leaving them no time to dry. 10.7 million African Americans were shipped on a Middle Passage, rinse and repeat. African American students are 3.8 times more likely to be suspended, resulting in 67,000 black high school dropouts, rinse and repeat. 1 in 9 African American males between the ages of 20 and 34 are in prison today. The U.S. prison system costs $80 billion, rinse and repeat. 77% of former prisoners are rearrested and rewashed within 5 years of being released, rinse and repeat, 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 rinse and repeat. Before completing the following steps, please be sure to recognize that our colors aren't dirty clothes. You can't wash away our race. Put down your detergent and put a stop to this never-ending cycle of rinse and repeat.
Comrades is ready.
Yo. Wow. Wow. Okay, so straight up goosebumps immediately. Jeez Louise. Okay, I didn't realize. I need to turn up the air conditioning up in the spot or get a fan or something, because it is way hotter than I expected, and my expectations were high. But our calibration poet, the incredible feature from our judge, Jasmine Manns, and then these first two poets in the slam. My goodness, rinse and repeat. We've talked about it, family. We've talked about it. It is our responsibility to break these cycles. But the poets have to diagnose for society exactly what cycles must be broken. Thank you for speaking truth to power. Thank you for speaking your truth. And thank you for coming with the heat. Sydney, what we got?
I feel you, because I didn't realize I might need a fan up in here.
Yeah, man.
It's turned up.
Yeah.
For that poet from Miami, from low to high, we have a 7.8,
what?
A 7.9, an 8, an 8.1, and an 8.8. But forget them scores. Tell them judges, listen to the poem in the comments. Please, it's bananas. Give it up for that poet from Miami, though.
Yo, listen, judges. I big y'all up, man. I big y'all up. Come on. Come on. I know where you live, judges. Don't forget that. All right, we're going to keep it going. We're going to keep it going. Exceptional poetry. Exceptional poetry. And it just underscores the fact that these scores are not clearly the marker of the quality of the work and the beauty of the spirit that performs the work. I'm so proud of you, poets. Let's keep going. Judges, listen to these poems. Yo, Los Angeles, you are on deck right now. Please welcome to the Brave New Voices screen poetry from Fayetteville, North Carolina. Let's go.
North Carolina will be bringing a video titled Diary of a Mad Black Woman. So how you gonna act? Relatances in the cutter, look for doing my business. Doing my business. Owen, drinking, throwing at the hullet. Solo, but on the loaf, my butt, my butt. Doing hella shit at one time. I definition a huffy minute. I'm in the building and I'm feeling like to the Mac, the RE. So don't stop. Keep it going, keep it going. Some privilege in the back. Blowing. Hold it down for the bay, rip it open. If it wasn't for the granddaddy smoking, that's just not me.
My mother always told me,
Be who God intended for you to be and do more than the world expects from you, you see. I am beautiful. I am strong. I am a woman. Woman because I don't have to speak to make a crowd rise from their seats. I'm a queen. Like my ancestors, despite what ignorant people may think, I'm sweet. Until your presence shakens my faith, I'll let you down easy and remove you from my face, out my life, and out my space. I'm social. Until you start a conversation that makes me slowly want to back away because what you're saying isn't sitting right with me. I'm catching levels on levels of your negative energy, and sometimes I get tired of Black men. Who tear us apart piece by piece, beating us cheek by cheek, making our hearts weep and weep, traumatizing us to the point where we don't know who to trust or who to believe. But I'm nice when you aren't using arrogant words to catcall and sexualize me. And I am so sick of the stereotype that Black women are always angry. Because I am Black, I am a woman, and I am not angry. I am pissed. So pissed that being a Black girl causes people to say the most stereotypical slurs. I'm mad. Mad by the media for making these allegations legitimately seem true. And you men don't make it no better when you shoot your shot and miss. Now I'm a trick and ugly to you. I'm furious. Furious because my downfall is America's miracle. That my struggles are the drug that you inhale. I'm pissed because I wake up every day knowing the world tried to kill me yesterday and failed. I am mad. Mad that boys will be boys and girls will be thoughts without thoughts. And if she thought about not wearing that outfit, then maybe she wouldn't have got caught. I'm mad at genocide. I am mad at poverty. I am mad at rapists. I'm mad I always got to be the one to say sorry for society's cycles of lies on repeat. I'm mad that when a white man gets killed, America jumps up on their feet. But when it's a Black man, we're left screaming, no justice, no peace. Now I'm crazy. Well, if I'm crazy, then maybe you should back away because I'm 5 seconds from going crazy on you. Today is not the day because it's always the Black girls, right? Ain't that what you white females say? I'm mad because I am in a generation where the girls and boys move at a fast pace. You're 14, 15, and 16. Sit down and stay in a child's place. Can't you see what's happening in this world today? And I am sick of hearing all Black women are loud because I can get a lot louder. I'm loud not because I'm a Black woman, but because a loud voice has power. I'm mad. I'm so angry, and I only have 3 minutes to tell you why. And I'm mad Black people can't never be on time. I am mad I have to love myself before I love anyone else. Because what if the love I need for myself, I have to first find in someone else? And I'm mad that if it's a competition between me and Karen, Karen's gonna always win. No, I ain't on my period, so don't ask me again. I'm mad if I go missing, the news ain't gonna assist it. But if I don't have a job, they want to interview me for the 2020 jobless nigga statistic. I'm mad at coronavirus. I'm mad there's a possibility I will not survive childbirth labor. I'm mad every time someone needs something, they always have to ask the Black woman for the favor. I'm mad that half of this world lives under a rock. And when white people see racist stuff happening, they get to decide whether they want to see color today or not. I am mad. I am irritated. I'm pissed off. I'm tight. But my mom always told me that haters are a Black woman's stepping stool, which explains why I am not afraid of heights.
Tell them why you mad, son. Tell them why you mad. Listen, you got a right. Man, shout out to Solange. One more time. Please give it up, Brave New Voices, for that exceptional poem coming out of Fayetteville, North Carolina. I feel like I'm not just watching the BNV finals. I feel like I'm watching the NBA finals. I feel like I am sitting home cheering at these screens. I feel exuberant. I feel uplifted. I feel motivated. I don't know who exactly my neighbors are, but they're going to know who I am by the time this night is over, because I am screaming out here in my living room. Yes, shout out to the chat, and their nails were fire. So it's like that. Cindy, what do the judges say?
For that poet from Fayetteville, from Low to High, we have a 7.8, oof, 7.9, an 8.1, and an 8.5. But I don't care what the judges say. Did you see that mug at the end? Ooh. Did you see it? I looked into the eyes of that poet.
Through the screen. Afraid of heights, yo.
Through the screen. I felt it. And so Forget them scores. Give it up for that poet from Fayetteville, y'all.
Yeah, man. Exceptional, exceptional work. I'm so proud. You know, judges, at the very least, man, y'all are being consistent. I appreciate that you've set a level. My goodness, it's incredibly competitive because the quality of the poems is incredibly high. Yeah, snaps all around. Much, much, much love to all the poets. Listen, we have one more poem in the first round, and then we're going to skip straight ahead to the second round. So Miami Gardens, you are on deck to start the second round. But to close out the first round, please get lit for the team from Los Angeles, California, y'all. Give it up, Brave New Voice.
Record like a DJ. That's 150 bottles in one night. I get it, act right, act right, act right. Money don't fold, is it act right?
Home from Natalie Heredia. Act right.
Playing games, get it act right. Going, back to the base. Rest in peace, Mac Dre. On the screen, all I do is talk, yeah. Homie in your city, you know they gon' pay. I ain't looking for a free throw, looking for a free throw.
The live poem from Natalie Heredia.
This is how I breathe. Sometimes I wonder what it's like to be privileged. I imagine that I live in a big blue house and I walk into my house filled with the scent of fresh lasagna. When I'm done eating, my private tutor comes to help me with my pre-calc homework. Then after 26 problems of how to use trig functions, I walk to the bathroom and shower. When I'm out, I blow dry my blonde hair and rest my head to sleep in my own bed, in my own room. Then and only then am I awakened back into reality when I hear, La negra tiene tumbao, coming from the living room of my small apartment. I walk out of the one bedroom we have and see my mother brooming to the rhythm of Celia Cruz. On the table, I see still Honey Nut Cheerios. My dinner for the third night in a row. I'm reminded that I'm not privileged and that I have to work for what I have and want. I have to get on my knees and deep clean the bathroom before I can leave the house. I have to watch videos on YouTube from 2008 on trig functions because my mother never made it to pre-calc. Then what really pulls me back into reality is when my hips start to sway to the sound of the music. I realize at that moment, I am definitely Hispanic. I realize I get to build character based on the trials I face every day because my skin is a couple notches darker than my classmates. I realize I get to learn how to handle awkward stares from my rich peers when I say I've lived in a one bedroom with two other people for 17 years of my life. I realize I get to say I have my 4.0 GPA because of hard work and determination. I start to understand that I am privileged. I am privileged and proud to be Hispanic. Privileged that I live in a small apartment because I never feel apart from my family. Privileged that I get to teach myself math because some people don't get to say that. I am privileged that I get to eat cereal because some people don't get to eat anything at all. I immediately destroy the fantasy in my mind and tell myself, Estoy satisfecha. I am satisfied.
Yes, yes, go off, poet. Big up. Much, 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 much love for the poet from Los Angeles representing LA. It strikes me as we end round one that we have four hot spots represented. North Carolina is a swing state in this national election, and this slam is filled with poets who are not necessarily franchised into the electoral process, but are speaking their fire and speaking their truth, shaking the pillars of this country. We have two states represented here, that are current hotspots for the coronavirus in Florida and California. And we have the forever hotspot of St. Louis, Missouri, of course, in Ferguson County, birthplace of several movements, riots from the top of the century and riots in 2015. This is the United States today. And these poets representing truth, stability, and yes, the privilege of making it through struggle. I'm incredibly, incredibly proud of y'all. Go ahead. Hey, Sid.
What's good?
What it looking like, man?
Whew, you're so right. And I that's all I'm gonna say. Mm-hmm. From low to high for that poet, we have a 7.9, mm-hmm. 7.9, mm-hmm. an 8, mm-hmm. and an 8.9. But forget the scores and give it up for Natalie from LA. Wow.
Word up. Word up. Hey, one round done. One complete round done. Really exceptional work. I am uplifted. I would say I could go home now, but I'm home now. So there it is. Round two is going to look like this. We are going to hear from Miami Gardens. Then we are going to hear from Fayetteville. Then we are going to hear from Los Angeles. And to close out the second round, we're going to hear from St. Louis. Miami Gardens, Fayetteville, LA, STL. So Fayetteville, you are on deck. Brave new voices. Let's give it all our strength for the poet from Miami Gardens. Let's go.
All right, nigga, we gon' be all right. We gon' be all right. Do you hear me? Do you feel me? We gon' be all right. Nigga, we gon' be all right. Huh? We gon' be all right. Nigga, we gon' be all right. Do you hear me? Do you feel me? We gon' be all right.
And when I wake up, I recognize you looking at me for the pay cut. Bahamas, I be looking at you from the face down. One Mac 11, need the room with the bass down. Skimming. 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 Skimming.
Skimming. Skimming. Ever hear a black boy speak? Voice of mahogany, authority, trying to contradict the institutionalized instinct to question everything that he says, yet the words flow out his mouth like honey. Ever hear a black boy sing? A low rumble that begins in the throat and travels all the way to the fingertips. A rumble that makes even the mountains fall to their knees at the sound of a single note. A rumble that is imitated, appropriated, but with blonde hair and privilege don't quite come out the same ever. See a black boy dance, dancing. Not with the weight of an ocean, but the fluidity of a river. Eyes closed, faint smile, hips swaying, dancing. Not for those around him, but for his ancestors, dancing to the beat of their oppression ever. See a black boy smile, the type of smile that lights up a whole universe, that outshines the sun itself, that looks like velvet, feels that lasts for lifetimes until it fade away ever. See a black boy wince, wincing once when he steps out of line, twice when his eyes wander or his lips misspeak and he's reminded that he's still a boy, will always be a boy no matter how old he is. Eyes on the ground, hand and plain sight thing around his neck, yanking him back into place ever. See a black boy cry, frustrated tears that we could defeat and spoil pride, tears that wipe away carefully constructed mask of artificial toughness, tears that never see the light of day, but only allowed out in the comfort of darkness, tears that match his mother who would never let him walk out that door in the first place ever. See a black boy ball his fist ever. See a black boy prepare for battle, streets taught him how to defend himself, right? Never flight, only fight, as if he could take on each and every injustice with his own two hands. A fire inside only dim when he realized they brought a gun to a knife fight ever. See a black boy bleed when he's lying there on the ground, surrounded by his crimson crown. Is that when he is labeled non-threatening? Is that when the appeal of having dark skin finally crosses the line? Cause everyone wanna act black until it's time to be black, and no one wants to play dead in these streets, slowly collecting innocence, you see. Contrary to popular belief, when a black boy bleed, he don't just bleed red.
He bleeds red and white and blue, his body physically grieving for a country he gave his everything to, yet refused to love him back, refuses to love him back when a black boy bleeds. The world stops just for a second as Mother Nature mourns her forsaken son.
I'm not crying, you're crying. I'm not crying, you're crying. Come on, poet. Let's go, poet. Give it up, brave new voices. For the young artist from Miami Gardens, representing Miami Gardens. Look at you go in. Y'all, let's talk about the relationship between spoken language and body language. Let's talk about how the vulnerability in the words of the poem matched the music in the body language of the poem. That is beautiful theater. It is beautiful literature, cut straight to the heart. Thank you so much for sharing that. I, you know, as a father of an 18-year-old son myself, I appreciate these odes. As the father of a 15-year-old daughter, I appreciate these odes. I appreciate what the power that we are speaking very specifically to an unheralded experience. Thank you for speaking this truth. Sydney, to you, fam.
What's good? For that amazing poet from Miami, from low to high, we have an 8, an 8.2, mm-hmm. an 8.2, mm-hmm. an 8.6, and a 9, but give okay, it up for that poet. Okay, despite okay. the scores, I Ooh. See the chat going nuts.
Yeah, so it has to. You already know. You already Ooh. Know. We, you know, this is church right up in here. I can't,
all up in here.
I can't believe it. Yeah, man, I'm on the East Coast. The sun is setting. It just feels, I'm uplifted. I'm uplifted. Right. I don't know how many times I'm going to say that. Every time I say uplifted, just drink take a shot of water. You know what I'm saying? Get hydrated. Right. Okay, so Los Angeles, you are on deck right now. Brave new voices. Brave new voices, wherever you're at, clap your hands as you're able. Stomp your feet if you can. Give it up, please, for the artist representing Fayetteville, North Carolina. Let's go.
Fayetteville is bringing up a pre-recorded video titled Dichotomy, Trigger Warning for Racist Terminology. Daddy always comes home with a smile, tells me I'm his special child. That's why he risks his life to protect and serve.
My life may not be perfect, but the situation is not what I deserve. I don't even know why I'm being pulled over. I'm just on my way to work.
Dad works in areas where he can easily get hurt. Committing a crime there can get you your own protest.
I don't want to be a catalyst for the next social unrest. I just want to get to work and after that, go to class.
When Dad comes home each night, we don't want it to be his last, so we tell him to do whatever is necessary to survive those criminals.
I know people who face executions for doing the minimal. People tell me if I act right, I shouldn't be scared, but I shouldn't have to prove my worth to live because that isn't fair. Why do I have to go through this? Is anyone even listening out there?
Yes, I hear you, but my dad is a good man. I'll try to say this so that you can understand that our civil servants are needed in this messy world, making need of those with bad moral hygiene. This means they deal with the people responsible for their own killing. Spilling blood but can't clean up their own act. Here's a fact. Black people kill each other at a at a rate 8 times higher than whites, but then march in parades that demand human rights?
I hear your voice, but this country gave us a little choice. Starve or steal, kill or be killed by our own. The short places we called home, like the burning of Black Wall Street and Wilmington, NC, you see. Segregation and redlining left us mining in bankrupt earth. Rose out of slavery just to be brought back to the dirt. Black people are the coal this country needs to burn. White supremacy gives you blood diamonds you didn't even earn, that you used to cut us out with laser precision, and we're left to fight over meager welfare provisions. Ghettos were all this country had to offer.
You're the only ones to suffer. My forefathers did what difficult situations required. For you, this country's been nothing but a provider, misbranding our nation to fabricate your criminal tendencies. Y'all ghettoed up white privilege and now claim it's white supremacy? Created this white people image, now we're the modern day enemy? Blacks who don't abide by the law make their own lives hard. But when you're caught, the first thing you do is play the race card. We're sick of it.
This system was built for your benefit. Black people, the ones it was built to oppress. It started with slavery. Hunters herding us back to our abusers, users. Now the police herd us back to heaven because we dare to want freedom? We hung from trees for any petty offense. When your troubled youth like Dylan Roof receives mercy for his recompense, but we're considered thugs when we get caught breathing while driving. We are dying in a system in which you are thriving.
To me, it seems like you are talking about the past.
And when did you check your newsfeed last? Black people are hanging like strange fruit all over this nation.
And the police are the ones you will call to conduct the investigation.
If America would leave us alone, we wouldn't have to call. From the very beginning, this place has been plotting our downfall.
You need us.
You used us.
Well, what you're saying might be true, but just like me, America loves my father more than it loves you.
Which is why we march, resist, and fight for room to breathe. Change is on the horizon, and your kind is a dying breed.
Trade my 4x4 for G63, ain't no more. I gave him chance, a chance, a chance again.
Yo. It's like that. It's like that. That's the kind of dialogue, man. That's the kind of back and forth, that's the kind of discourse that you know, may be more pervasive right now in the current moment. You might see it in the streets, you might see it on CNN or your local broadcast, but that dialogue right there is what Brave New Voices has been doing for 23 years. For a full generation, young poets not talking across each other, not at each other, but with each other. That's right. Thank you for the chat. Hard conversations. But who else is going to initiate those hard conversations if not for you, the artist? Who's going to set the edge for this country if it's not you, the artist? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for bringing that up, for doing it masterfully, for somehow across this this landscape, this pandemic landscape, managing and organizing to put this to put that piece together. Shout out to the group piece, incredible work. Hey Sid, what's happening over there?
Ooh, I love the conversation. Mm-hmm. And shout out to all the youth who've been just having these important conversations in forums all week, in yes. town halls, in late nights. Folks have been gathering and having tough conversations, and so adding that piece to the conversation, just whew, the energy in the room was wild. For that piece, that group piece from Fayetteville, from low to high, I have a 7.5, an 8, an 8.2, an 8.4, and an 8.5. But forget the scores. Give it up for that conversation, y'all.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Shout out, shout out, shout out. And I just want to lift something up from Fayetteville that's up in the chat. We want to reaffirm. Yeah. We just want to reaffirm that the poet expressing a hard or a harder view or perspective that's in alignment with the historical marginalization and criminalization of the Black body. Those are not her beliefs. She is not racist at all. I am lifting that up from the chat, although all of us are fighting the legacy of white supremacy. So adopt the voice, but not the perspective in the name of art. All right, St. Louis, you are on deck, but right now, Brave New Voices, we about to go in with Team Los Angeles. Give it up for LA.
A live poem from Nyre Francis.
This is how I breathe. Look. Look at my hooves. Worn always like this. Used to be pink like my two pig brothers. But the wind turned them to this lifeless chalk. All because that plastic pawed metal lung wolf been whistling, walking in my town. So to preserve the city, I joined the LAPD, the Los Angeles Pig Department. It started with my brothers Spot and Patchy. We were all going on what to build a house with. Spot says, make the walls out of straws. Patchy replied, but we gotta save the turtles. I explained, no, you dumbass, straws like hay. Then he went on about some brittle with sticks crap. Speaking of crap, some wolves will din across the street. I was in my car when I saw him. He looked over at me with his copper eyes, the hairs on my chinny chin stand. I say, hey, what are you doing here? And he walks away. That's how you know they're criminal. You know how wolves be. Strolling past my house on purpose. I know what they want. Speaking of house, last night, some animals swiped my bricks. I know that untamed dog took it. Still from me, this is my house. Know what I'm saying? I patrol here, people, to see me. I deserve justice. Even if he can't lift a grain of salt, he's guilty of something. I see him walking. I say, hey, what are you doing here? And the wolf rolls his eyes at me like shit dice, like I'm a stray cat or invisible. So I say, hey, I've been meaning to talk to you. What you roaming around for? He yells, why are you following me? Don't you know I'm the LAPD? Doesn't matter. And I'm off duty. This pig is still a pig without the uniform. You will always be a wolf in wolf clothing. I know you stole my bricks. All you wolves are the same. I said, my hatred. This hatred is yours fault. And he walks away. So I chase. I say, hey, listen. See my pointy hood shit? Look, look. You turned my hands to dust, but now they're back, they're covered red. Detectives say he didn't steal my bricks. Now everyone thinks it was my job to keep the neighborhood safe. I hear the city say they don't need me, but that won't do a bullet. I can't bring you back to life. I can only forgive myself. City, say you had a family. But what about me? Are you here? Can you see me? Tell the people they should see me.
Goosebumps. My heart is sweating. My heart is sweating. You know how wolves be? Come on. Come on, poet. Come on, originality. Come on, conceit. Come on, narrative. Come on, performance. Unreal. Unreal. Extraordinary. Superb. I'm loving this. I'm loving this. Yeah, who said giving me Patricia Smith vibes? Yup. Maida, I see you. I see you. And that is high praise. That is high praise. Conceptually excellent, Los Angeles. Fantastic. Incredibly proud. And shout out to our DJ, Dion Decibels. I see you just picked it up right there. Thank you, thank you, thank you. At least someone is listening to the poem. Speaking of, Sid, Wagwan. Okay.
I love the way that conversation just happened. Like, the last two pieces just, woo! Whew, the youth are doing it. Forget the scores. The youth are making it happen.
Yes.
Shout out to y'all. For real, for real. From low to high, we have a 7, an 8.4.
Come on. Yeah. Dog.
Make that noise again, Bamuthi, for me. From low to high again, we have a 7, an 8.4, an 8.5, a 9, and a 9.3, y'all. But that don't make no sense. Give it up for LA, y'all.
Give it up for LA. Give it up for LA. That was exceptional. Thank you for the work. Thank you for putting that work into the world, y'all. We are going to quickly move to the end of round 2. Bringing up now the artists from the city that started the slam off. Y'all, please give it up for St. Louis on the mic. Hey.
Just a little. You supposed to hold me down, but you're holding me back. And that's the sound. I mean, I'm calling you.
St. Louis will bring up a poem, a pre-recorded poem of Icarus.
Best friend set me down in the salon chair. Shampoo press get you out of my hair. Fresh photos with the bomb lighting. New man on the Minnesota Vikings. True hearts needed something more exciting.
I picked the last bits of him out of my hair just for him to call. Tell me he's written a new poem about me. About two girls, actually, that he tried so carefully to hide behind metaphors. One being the string of a kite keeps him grounded, reminds him where home is. The other is the kite, keeps him lifted, shows him what it could be like to fly. I tell him he sounds like Icarus, knows he cannot fly too close to the sun. Knows that's exactly where I'll take him and show him nothing but wildfires. I guess he's smart. Because unlike Icarus, he decides to stay near the water. Says it's probably what's best, that the water is predictable. Sun tells him, I've never known water to be predictable. Don't they name the most catastrophic hurricanes after women? I mean, if you're gonna play with something that's not safe for you, wouldn't you rather play with fire? He stops me in my flames, starts distracting me with metaphors, says the sun's beauty can't be put into words, though I smile, because I am the sun, and I cannot be put into words. But then I frown, because he still wrote about two girls. So who is the water? Who is this other girl, and why does he hide her behind metaphors? Is it because she keeps your heart at bay? Is it because you look at her and know where home is? But what's a home if it's always cold? Especially if I could keep you warm in this one. Look at me. Know this is where your life can begin. Let me be your sun. Be the reason you know it's okay to wake up in the morning. Be the glory you bask in on a hot summer's day. Before I get too lost in the metaphors, Icarus cuts me off. Says it isn't that serious. I frown because he is Icarus, but in my head, I smile because maybe it's okay for him to be completely unsure about whether he should go for a swim or take a walk in the sunshine. But honestly, I think he should scratch this. Just rewrite the poem or maybe not mention me in the first place because the sun isn't what's best for him. Maybe it's easier to drown than burn. See, the story of Icarus is not a poem. But for some reason, he's my favorite one. I mean, wouldn't you want to fly? But maybe Icarus wasn't shit. And to think he could conquer both sun and water without being burnt alive or swallowed whole. I don't want to be his favorite part of a poem. Don't want him taking in only parts of me. Nigga, I am the poem. You know what? I should just get off the phone. Should leave him there. Sitting in the cold, wet, and shivering with nothing but a lifeless piece of string. And fuck your poem, because you need to rewrite it.
Yes. Exceptional work. I am the poem. Rewrite that shit. Excellent work. Shout out St. Louis, representing right here. Family, look how quickly that went. Round one, down. Round two, done. Fire work from everybody, man. And you all as audience, consistent, representing all four time zones. And this here, United's actually, there are more than four time zones, but all four time zones definitely on the continental United States. Shout out to Alaska, shout out to Hawaii, man. Shout out to all the territory, shout out to all 50 states. Somehow this thing, these united snakes, somehow we cut through it all the venom of this country, in which y'all are giving our pure love. Shout out to our ASL interpreters. I see you. Thank you. Shout out to our closed captioning. Thank you to our DJ. The production crew is lit, and hopefully so are these scores. Sid, what'd it look like?
Oh, I love that poet. From low to high, we got an 8. An 8.1, an 8.1, an 8.5, and an 8.5. Give it up for that energy, that poet from STL, baby.
All right, shout out. You know, judges, I'm giving you a hard time, but I am noticing that y'all are holding the line. All I know is that it's not your scores that are moving me. It is these poems that are moving me. Thank you, poets. Thank you, y'all, brave new voices. Y'all, that was the end of round two. I am very, very fortunate to let you know that before we go on a little bit of a break, we have two dynamic performances from two dynamic performers. The first person that I'm gonna bring up to this space is the winner of the MC Olympics. Yes. So Malik, my friend, winner of the MC Olympics, please step to the BNV screen, y'all. Shout out, MC Olympic champion, my fam, Malik. Hey.
As I look around, I notice that there's too much going on, so I tell life that they can wait. So sometimes it be right on the nose, thinking about my head in the clouds. I open chapters just to close them out. A prequel to my life is something that I needed. My body is a substitution. My past life just left me wait to deal with retribution. Meditation and doing is just as time consuming. And I need one more day for the time. Life can wait. I told him life can wait. I told him life can wait. I told him life can wait. So, just light the way. We all walk our own path. I need one night to stay. Shut the blinds, read my mind. I got my mind away. Never mind, I'm on my grind. I cannot fight this pain. In blackest day and brightest night, we light to light despite these times. Revitalized and truest times. I need a break for my health and I cannot fight this time. You ever felt so tired, hard to keep this tight inside? Nah. Sometimes I be right on the nose. Thinking about my head in the clouds. I open chapters just to close them out. A prequel to my life is something that I needed. My body is a substitution. My past life just left me wait to deal with retribution. Meditation and doing is just a time consuming. And I need one more day for the time. Life can wait. And now you know I like to fight, but still. The way the world ciphers a viper might be the reason to keep a Bible still. Let's pretend that everything is all right. And it's going to stay the way until a rapper prove he can write. I always ignore advice. And I just turn off my lights. My thoughts controlling my mind. As Nikes distract my science. A poet don't ever eat good when it comes down to it. We question everything else and bid farewell to it. A couple intermissions in my life where I get a break. Savannah City turns a blind eye to me once again. But I ain't hurting and I ain't showing it neither. My process is dropping bodies and I don't care about it neither. I'm saying, and by the bing to them reapers and demon seeds of the feeds, I throw a piece of who bleeding like me, like we all agreed. Nah, we hate to see if fate could be just baiting me to a late degree or simply pump fake. And I tell the Lord, please, Won't you remember my name? Won't you remember my name? My name. But I'm so lucky that I forget to text him back. You know how hoes be. I look myself inside a mirror, put a penny to my thoughts and send a message to the God for wishing. Don't forget my past subscription. This how the Lord's be. Well, I have nobody to blame except my home screen. Well, I be back up on my lonely. The Genesis was so be it, so be it, so be it. Now 16 snow in the bluff missions to ease my mental. It's deep depression, open book, but I'm still obsessing. Real depiction, I'm birthing pain, would you listen? It's Judas and Mary's in the system, marijuana, convictions, illusions. Bucket of water for those in destitution. Solution, wash our sins in water and claim a retribution. Be water, the motherland. I walk 15 minutes down the road to quench my thirst. America, 15 minute life sentence as soon as I'm stressing as an adolescent and I'm yelling so desperate. And I charge my key as a nomad in these dope raps one by one as I bless y'all. BNV, thank y'all for having me.
Yeah. Shout out Malik, champion of the MC Olympics, representing Senegal. I see you, family. Shout out to the continent. The room was literally lit. So thank you. Loving the decor. All right, I'm feeling you. Hey, so we have one more artist that's going to rock with us. This artist is coming straight from the Shy, but also straight down from the judge's box. Y'all, please give it up for literally one of my favorite poets on the planet. Shout out, shout out, shout out, and much love to Maida Del Valle stepping to the stage. Y'all, give it up for Maida Del Valle.
What's up, what's up, what's up, BNV? Much love to all the poets. Oh my God, y'all are amazing. So my time is short, so I want to get to this piece. Today marks 1 year since the uprisings in Puerto Rico, where the people of Boricuan ousted the governor, Ricardo Rosselló. And I started writing this poem right around Hurricane Maria, put it down for some time, and picked it up again when the uprisings were happening. And I'm gonna read two parts of this poem. It's a really long piece. It's about 20 minutes. It's in 9 parts. I'm gonna read two pieces from this for you tonight. This piece is called Novena to Guavan Sex, a funeral rite in 9 parts, or Crónicas from a Daughter of the Diaspora. So for those who don't know, Guavan Sex is the Taino goddess of hurricanes and of wind and of storms. And a novena is a Catholic prayer ritual that takes place over the course of 9 days, and it's traditionally prayed after someone dies. So just to give you a little bit of context. So these two pieces, this is from the 7th day of the novena. This is the day of rage. A short list of grievances from the colonial subjects of Puerto Rico: Columbus, Salcedo, Ponce de Leon, the invasion of sovereign land, the genocide of native Tainos, the enslavement of kidnapped Africans, the imposition of American citizenship, the radioactive torture of Pedro Albizu Campos, toxic ashes in Peñuelas, the selling off of beaches in Playuela, the Promesa Bill, La Junta, an unaudited debt, university tuition hikes, austerity cuts, cuts to the minimum wage, 283 schools shut down in a single year, 42 women murdered in a single year, the biggest exodus of people from the island since the 1950s, a crumbling infrastructure, decades of corruption, 526 years of colonial rule. On the 7th day, the kindling was just waiting to be lit, and Ricky struck the match with his stateside educated mamabicho entitlement. The putas, the patos, Maria's dead. All fodder for laughs and bro slaps on the back. Let's be clear, Ricky was just another payaso, an effigy of white patriarchy dressed up in an accented name, de los riquitos, who've always licked the boots of America with their desperate, drooling tongues. On the 7th day, the people show the world what it means to become a hurricane. What happens when the mask gets ripped away? What happens when weariness transforms to war? On the 7th day, the people come prepared, gas masks and vinegar, pots, pans, and wooden spoons, planeras and cowbells, lungs, fists, and bodies, flags and bullhorns, bomba, batucada, on foot, on horseback, on jet skis, on yoga mats, on motorcycles, relentlessly shouting at the entrance of the old Spanish mansion. Until the sun sets, until the tear gas is unleashed, until the smoldering canisters are thrown back in defiance. Nos quitaron tanto que nos quitaron el miedo. There is nothing more dangerous to a government than a person who's lost everything, including their fear. On the seventh day, we remember that our very existence is an act of resistance. The eighth day, el Día de Agua, prayed in honor of El Santísimo Bad Bunny. On the eighth day, the people conjure water, hundreds of thousands of bodies flooding onto the streets, taking over the highway, faces turned to the sky, fists raised like azabaches against the steel gray storm clouds. They dance and shout to the god of the mountain, todo lo mío es también, until the sky breaks open and they call forth the fleeting relief of rain, coolness falling over the clamor and the heat, and everyone prays. Ricardo Antonio Rosello Nevarez, may all of your nights henceforth be sleepless. May whatever enclosure you find yourself in be filled with the echoes of cacerolazos. May Maria's muertos come to keep you company every night, trailing their cold fingers over your face, making the hairs on the back of your neck stand at permanent attention, an army of regret chilling your spine like the refrigerated trucks they were forced to lie in. This is Olimpia. This is how you do despojo for a nation. This is a return to sender spell, a hex breaker, a candle from Marta la Dominadora. This is the guarapo your grandmother showed your mother how to make. This is the baño she used to soothe her susto. This is the wall full of santos and prayer cards she kept in the sanctum of her bedroom. This is guaban sex. This is olla, disguised as the huracan that changes everything. The ninth day, el día de perreo. The day of celebration, the day of the resignation. It is only fitting that the revolution happens on the day of perreo. Un perreo pero bien sucio. Un perreo combativo. Un perreo revolucionario. On the day the putas pero bien putísimas stand on the stairs of the cathedral waving flags and ash cheeks under the glare of stone saints. On the day even their naked tetas are a protest, nipples pointed to the sky like bullets, the choir of lungs unleashing, soy pata, soy puta, pero nunca corrupta. On the day they consecrate the most sacred of spaces, the grimiest of dance floors, the scent of frankincense and myrrh fading under the funk of sweat dripping down crevices and cracks like agua bendita, the drone of dembow beats making every inch of flesh bounce, twerk and twist, whine and grind against the porcelain egos of men who lean against the wall with nowhere to escape from the writhing rhythm of waists and nalgas. Blessed be the putas, the patas, blessed be the dykes and queens, blessed be the non-penitents, the disrespectful, disgraceful, and depraved. Blessed be the outcast, the unbaptized, and the sinners who hold ball in front of the church like all the children of the witches they couldn't burn returned to haunt the marble sanctuary, the pews and confessionals. May they raise this pound of quivering flesh like a host so it becomes sanctified. Amen. A litany from Maria Milagrosa. Our Lady of the Conquistadores, pray for us. Our Lady of the Diaspora, pray for us. Mother of colonial subjects, mother of stolen lands, pray for us. Our Lady of depleted uranium, pray for us. Our Lady of refrigerated trucks, pray for us. Our Lady of long distance phone calls to La Isla, pray for us. Our Lady of inherited nostalgia, Our Lady of slurred Spanish, Nuestra Señora de la S Comida, pray for us. Our Lady of the blue tarps, ruega por nosotros. Our Lady of FEMA, ruega por nosotros. Mother of bottled water, Our Lady of napalm testing and forced sterilization, ruega por nosotros. Nuestra Señora de la Salchicha, Our Lady of the generator, Our Lady of the electricity that never fails us, ruega por nosotros. Nuestra Señora del Machete, Our Lady of the Exodus, pray for us. Our Lady of the Revolución, pray for us. Nuestra Señora del Perreo, Our Lady of Cold Medallas, Our Lady of the souped up 78 blue Toyota, pray for us. Nuestra Señora de la Bolita, Nuestra Señora de Mucho Ojo, ruega por nosotros. Nuestra Señora de los Cacerolazos, Nuestra Señora de la Generación, yo no me dejo, ruega por nosotros. Your 8 million children seated across the waters, carried by the blessing of your breath, have mercy on us. Amen. Thank you so much, BMV.
Amen, amen, amen. Hey, family. First of all, let it be said, ain't no suckers at BMV. just let it be said, right? Whackness is not allowed. There are many things that are not allowed on the Brave New Voices ground. Whackness is not allowed. My goodness. Mata Del Valle, who I've known for an awful long time, makes me feel every time like the first time, which is something. Shout out to our judges, shout out to our poets, shout out to this Brave New Voices family. Ayo, Dion Decibels, let's take like a 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 minute break. It is 8:01 according to the clock. Let's come back everybody at 8:09 and start the second half of the slam. Y'all, this is DJ Dion Decibels on the ones and twos. We'll see you in 9 minutes.
Semejante gotita, agüita, agüita. Lo que estamos activos, movemos los pies, renegita. Un pasito muy fino, y el flota divino. De mi mami le estilo todito caliente, me salto los tibios. Agüita, agüita, llueven diosita. Las más finas hijitas me caen distintas gracias a la vida. Es que soy un berraco salvaje, pero suave chinchila. Me meto rumba con tacón en pie, a veces me maquilla. Se me acerca una nena chimbita, nos pegamos seguida. Un pasito, tun, tun, ey, hacemos la vuelta, agüita, agüita. Recuerdo los tiempos difíciles cuando yo no tenía. Ando mamado estos días, que frío, ojalá no me dé pulmonía. Yeah, yeah. Desde el barrio de Brooklyn lo mueven hasta San Basilio. En la lata se escucha todo, en Bogotá pone enemigo. Cada loca es su tema, yo al peluche del río. A ver si le muestro un nuevo estilo, estoy en Panamá, oh Dios mío. Diferente la pista, salpican gotitas. Agüita, 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 agüita. La lluvia bendita, la lágrima limpia. Agüita, 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 agüita. Diferente la pista, salpican gotitas. Agüita, 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 agüita. La lluvia bendita, la lágrima limpia. Agüita, 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 agüita.
Me conviene el chorro que mamera, canto todo sin pinche. Pero nunca suelto la manguera, agua cero, agüita. La llave tampoco se cierra, volteando joyita. Empapada la nena sudando, como medio campeón. Los pequeños nos aguantan, ya estamos jodidos. Semejante aguacero, agüita, 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 agüita. Rapidito lo mueven pa' abajo, pa' arriba, pa' abajo, pa' arriba. Qué rico lo mueven pa' abajo, pa' arriba, pa' abajo, pa' arriba.
Me conviene meterle en la vaina, los muchachos lo piden. Tan divino el chamaco Gabriel, por Dios que me lo cuide. A los pocos de chi, 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 esa lluvia muy lenta. Put the bag by the piano, Aretha. Go play with my Franklin. Le canto los gustos Benjamín, también hay de 50. Agüita, agüita, me sobra piscina, tu lluvia muy lenta. Le canto los muertos Benjamín, también hay de 50. Agüita, agüita, me sobra piscina, tu lluvia muy lenta. Diferente la pista, salpican gotitas. Agüita, 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 agüita. La lluvia bendita. La lágrima limpia, agüita, 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 agüita. Diferente la pista, salpican gotitas. Agüita, 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 agüita. La lluvia bendita, la lágrima limpia. Agüita, 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 agüita.
Don't catch you slipping up. Look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now. This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Look how I'm living now. Police be tripping now. Yeah, this is America. Guns in my area. I got the strap. I gotta carry 'em. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go into this. Yeah, yeah, this is gorilla. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go get the bag. Yeah, yeah, or I'ma get the pad. Yeah, yeah, I'm so cold like, yeah. Yeah, I'm so dull like, yeah. We gon' blow like, yeah. Look what I'm whipping up. Look how I'm geeking up. I'm so pretty. I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty. I'm gonna get it. Watch me move. This is Sally. That's a tool.
Yeah.
On my Kodak. Black. Oh, know that.
Like color, sweet money, like color.
I needed some shit with some bopping. I flew past the whip with that in my mouth, watched it swerving. That whip had a cop in it. My bitch got good, fly her across the country. I finished the show and I hop in it. I got me a milli, I did it legitly. I'm still with the shits, I'm a hot. Oh, you asking for pictures with niggas? What's your name? Get the fuck out the spot. I'm trying to figure which deal I'ma take. I woke up, couple meal on my plate. Gave mama 100. Probably won't hear me open my mouth. Bless you hearing me talking about finding some money.
Let's go.
As soon as I found that, I flipped that. Yeah. I'm a little bit different. They get it.
They did.
No, I'm stiff on the bitch. She did. Trying to find out why baby ain't all in the mentions. No, she ain't get no DM from me. This wrist, it ain't free. She be throwing that. Yeah, she good at it. Turn around when we fuck, make her look at it. She like, ha. I needed some shit with some bopping.
Let's go.
I flew past the whip with that in my mouth, watched it swerving. That whip had a cop in it. Hey, my bitch got good, fly her across the country. I finished the show and I hop in it. I got me a milli, I did it legitly. I'm still with the shit, I'm a hot. Let's hot. I'm on orthodox than a muffin. Hey, when you gon' switch the flow? I thought you never asked. They fuck with me and ain't about what the fuck they be rapping about with.
Let's go, Dion.
Each his own. If you like it, I love it. Don't be no.
Yes, Stephen Morris. Come on. Chinaka Hodge, wherever you are, much love. Hey. Brave New Voices, you've been listening to the sounds of DJ Dion Decibels. That is my ace right there. Come on, Bay Area. Let's go, man. We traveled the world with that man. Obviously playing incredible music. Capped off by a true legend. A true legend. Stevie Wonder. Listen, man. Everyone that we've heard from so far is legendary. Truly, this is really incredible work. You know, in my mind, it's been capped off by two of the poets that I've appreciated for a long, long time, in Jasmine and in Maida. But it is the young people, family. It is the young people. It is the brave new voices that is really just blowing my mind, and everybody in my fucking building knows it. So shout out to Noise Complaints, shout out to Noise Ordinances, shout out to Not Giving a Fuck, because it's Brave New Voices, bro. We're not here to be quiet. So we are going to slide into round three of the slam, but we're going to ease it in as best as we can. Shout out Digable Planets. Before we get into the third round of the slam, we are going to have a feature performance by an incredible artist. Y'all, please shout out Brave New Voices to us to step into the stage, y'all. Let's go, BMV.
These systems are fine, we fine.
G6 volume lock, the fifth one and locks. I feel like the others. We're undercovers. We out here like fuck it, we're undercovers. Now we out here like fuck it. These systems are failing, we fight. That's also. Can a black rose grow? Can a black rose grow? All I do is pull up, yeah. I'm a fool if I think I can.
Hello, hello. I'm Astu, and I'm just really grateful to be here at the Brave New Voices Festival. Thank you guys so much for having me. I'm really excited to hear everyone perform, and I just think it's such a beautiful thing. I feel so blessed to be able to witness the power and the dreams of this generation. I feel really, really blessed. So congratulations to all the poets who have competed and who are here at the
Thank you. Wasn't sure what happened. Yo, it's that crazy shit, right? When you're doing this live, this is live TV. I was like, okay, did the thing just shut out? Am I frozen? No, we're not frozen. Okay. So we're going to keep sliding on. That was miraculous. Thank you, Astu. That was amazing. We are going to have one more featured performance, y'all, straight from the DC, from the DMV. Okay. Yeah, we hate the internet. We love the internet. We hate the internet. The internet makes this thing happen, but it also just leads to some tenuous moments. Okay, so we're gonna bring the next feature. They are representing DC, Maryland, and Virginia, DMV. These artists represent an organization that I'm familiar with and love. Y'all, this is Words, Beats, and Life. Shout out to the DMV and shout out to WBL. Let's go with our second feature of the second half of the Brave New Voices Finals. Let's go, WBL.
Hello, BNV. As a team, we wanted to share a quick statement of accountability and restoration before we perform our poem.
First, congratulations are in order to all the teams who participated this year. We can all agree that this new virtual experience has been exciting and different.
On Wednesday, July 22nd, our team representing the DMV and Words, Beats, and Life had a protest lodged against us for one of our poems, Shadows. We felt this was unfair, but at the end of the day, our coaches decided, although we didn't agree with the protest, we wouldn't further contest it.
We want to send our deepest apologies and take accountability to the fact that the next day, word got out about the situation and another team felt emotionally distressed from online actions that violated the code of conduct. For this, we are sorry and just as set as you guys are.
We want to make it clear that we were never censoring the competition. Our frustration stemmed mostly in the process. We just wanted to create art, be different, and have fun like everyone else, especially considering all of the wonderful possibilities of the virtual format.
Our goal is to always speak volumes through our poetry and to build community.
We are thankful for this opportunity to perform at Final Stage for the DMV community at large, and we are thanking our coaches especially for guiding us through this process.
Without further hesitation, we want to send up a pre-recording of our group piece, Shadows.
If I didn't define myself for myself, I would be crunched into other people's fantasies for me, and eaten alive. Audrey Lorde.
I observe her as she wakes up, never fails to fall straight to her knees and start praying to God.
I cling to them. I am breathing into their skin.
Her bed is full of memories and bad decisions from the night before. Regrettably drags her feet to the shower to wash away her guilt, wondering, do you hear me now, God?
I am a figure superimposed, born in the dark and been sticking to the sidewalk ever since, and since the day I dissolved into the sky on the sidewalk. I find gum mixed into graphs of my skin.
She dresses herself in forced smiles and jokes as the coping mechanism walks in faith but thinks,
Fuck God. My job is to lay witness to their existence. I am the sole constant outside of their own skin.
Runs often because every day is leg day when you're running from your problems.
As I run, we live in fear of being crowned because of our bodies. I'm always behind her because I feel a sort of comfort wrapped around her and I treat her like armor.
But I forget to protect the owner of my body. I know the flat silence of their body. Some days we are all too familiar, so I've memorized the place where my phantom meets their skin.
She slouches and I mimic her because I can feel what he says, but can't say what I feel. Because she hears the old man talk about her beautiful body.
His breath reeked of lust he claimed was compassion.
He touched them on the sidewalk and it seems ever since they've been trying to scrub him out of their skin.
Your body that I convinced myself I loved did not love me, wondering which part I gave you this time. And if I can manage yet again to love without ever getting it back, treated me more whorehouse than sanctuary, what are they worshiping, God?
And I want us to feel godly.
But how can we feel like that when we can't appreciate the godly of our own body?
The woman I follow can't stand the love she receives for the one thing we hate, the thing that attracts the men because we are art, an abstract body.
If this body is not fulfilling a void for you, then it is non-existent.
Shadow is letting you call me girl so I have an easier space to fit in between your teeth on the sidewalk. I am only teeth and breathing, blood and smile wrapped in skin.
The shadow who no one values. The one she wishes to part ways with and tells me to say my last farewell to her body.
Perhaps what is a shadow without a body?
When I try to take up space instead, I find myself seen by ghosts sinking into the corners. So I found a way to make the plaster walls a second skin.
I find it crazy how before you know me as somebody, I'm just some. Body.
Wow. Damn, Words, Beats, and Life. Wow. Amazing. Y'all, I don't know if I'm more impressed by the accountability and the maturity that it takes to acknowledge and to acknowledge that you may have trespassed on someone else, the depth, the honorability, the dignity, the humility. And then the poem was crazy. So thank you for continuing to innovate the form. And my Lord, what a beautiful poem. What an amazing tribute. So grateful. Listen, y'all, we're going to get into the second half of this slam. We are going to warm these judges up with a calibration poet for the second half. Y'all, the calibration poem comes out of Chicago, Illinois, under siege and resisting. Y'all, shout out to Chicago, the calibration poet for half two of the BNV finals. Let's go, fam.
On May 28, 2015, at a CPD station, two officers, rifles in hand, posed for a black suspect with antlers on his head, predator smiling at their latest catch.
My forefathers taught me when you see the wild deer approach lifting untamed,
you rest your hand against the barrel of the gun and feel the heat of power overcome you.
But I am not an animal.
Then kill the animal.
But I am not an animal.
Only a god can master the forest.
But I am not an animal.
We are the enforcers of the natural order.
In our city, black people are seen as animals.
Welcome to Chicago, one of the most diverse cities in America. Today, you will leave your nice white northern neighborhood and enter the jungle. Welcome to the south and west sides of Chicago.
Everywhere we go, there is the same police poke and prod waiting.
Wait, we must save the shots.
In South Shore, we found every opportunity to misfire.
A body at the barrel of their gun and my black body, not human, but criminal.
My crime, nigga, and their justification, a cell phone. When will we be able to call victims of police violence what they are, prey? And how much hunting does one have to do to be labeled a predator?
Don't be deceived by these devious creatures. These niggas, I mean animals, feed off each other. Cannibals!
Since when does my skin grant me a deadly sentence?
My death is not valid unless it's a black on black crime.
As you can see, the niggas often roam in packs.
Y'all beady stones in y'all cage, y'all call four corners getting home.
No wonder these four corners bust their nuts.
What?
Right, stop with these animals. You have to be very careful because they're turned aggressive. They are apex predators, but we are the alpha.
Just last week, a black boy was shot by monsters in blue. And the week before that, the same thing happened.
And the same thing happened before that.
You were only created for consumption.
They devour us.
Humanize us, make an example of our bodies.
Shame us for the same choices they make.
Black boy, hands above his head.
His coffee-colored branches reaching out in surrender.
His roots run the bondage soaked in salt water. If a black body falls in America and no one is around to hear it,
will anyone give a damn? Why does a black corpse only matter when it falls on camera? These abominations are harmful to the pure population.
Our existence as superior must be maintained.
We are being challenged, pushed to the point of extinction. To the bells, bells!
You turned us nameless. We want Panthers mobilizing our aggression.
Different animals, same color. We chain monkeys for fun.
Make Black Panthers an endangered species.
You can be a revolutionary like Fred.
And still be gunned down like a dog just for us to murder a movement in cold blood.
Cops get away with everything. Pigs like to make us feel filthy. Cops are the ones always playing dirty, but somehow we the animals.
Wow. Speak truth to power. Y'all know what's up in this here United States. You know what's happening in Portland. You know what's supposed to be happening in Oakland. You know what's supposed to be happening in Detroit. You know what's supposed to be happening in Chicago. You know what 45 is doing. You know what he's unleashing on this country. And here come the poets. here come the young poets of Chicago letting them know exactly what we're up against, that this is systemic and that we will resist. Incredibly proud of your revolutionary spirit, of your radical spirit, of you embodying, codifying, and articulating what this country is, and in your bodies what it could be. I'm incredibly proud of y'all. Hey, Sid, were the judges awake?
Y'all must have did something in that dance break and those speeches. Y'all woke the judges up. Okay. Shout out to those folks from Chicago, my hometown. They woke the judges up, y'all. From a low to high, we have an 8.2.
Okay.
We have an 8.6. Mm-hmm. But then we go to a 9.1, a 9.5, and our night first 10.
The first 10 of the night! Let's go. All right, we got to do it while it's hot. Yo, round three.
While it's hot, we got to go.
Listen, man, round three is going to go Fayetteville, Los Angeles, St. Louis, Miami Gardens. Last in the round is Miami Gardens. Third in the round is St. Louis. On deck is L.A. And first up to begin the second half of the 23rd annual Brave New Voices Slam is the team representing Fayetteville, North Carolina. Let's go, Fayetteville. Let's show them how it's done, y'all. BMV.
Fayetteville will be bringing up a live piece, Trigger Warning, Sexual Abuse.
Respect is reciprocal, even though one knows you're special.
This is how I breathe. I think I was about 8 when I was first addressed as a woman, which is funny, because at 8, I thought that woman meant princess whose beauty left men speechless. I guess I thought that princesses were respected. My fairy tale was shifted into a harsh reality when a man old enough to be my father told me that my butt looked good. 9. The first odd touch happened at 9. I had no sense of whether this touch was wrong or not. The moral correctness of this action wasn't something that I was old enough to understand, but details aren't something that I can get into. Skip to 11. 11 was when my body told itself that it was ready to become a woman. At first, I thought I was dying. I didn't know I had to go through a scary red initiation, but the joke was on me. A man had already decided that I was a woman before my own body did. 11 was when I began taking the catcalls as compliments and convinced myself that their barking was what marked me valid. 11 was the year I was introduced to the consequences of my body. 12. I had my first kiss. It was forced and it felt wrong, and I didn't know why, but I went with it. Sandpaper lips scratching against my own, my subconscious warnings falling on deaf ears. 13. My best guy friend grabbed my boob and said that they were nice. I backed away, but I said, thank you. I said, thank you, when I really should have said, screw you. Screw you for thinking that my body is something that you're entitled to, but I said, thank you. Later that night, I still felt his hand imprinted on my chest. 13, my best guy friend bruises my wrist after I tell him not to touch me. After I tell him that he's made me uncomfortable, he tells me that he's sad, which has nothing to do with my point, but whatever. He's broken and needs me to hold him together. I stay. That same day, he tries to grope me, and all I can do is think about the blue-green painting he left on my wrist. 14. My senior boy grabs my thigh in the weight room, a buff redhead with an even bigger ego, jagged hands grating against me, scraping the lower layered coating off. He only stopped when I told him how old I was, but the damage to my shield had been done already. 15, mentally, the most draining year. But I figured out that my body is my own. It turns out other people aren't aware of that fact. My friend still tries to touch me, still says that he'll kill himself if I cut ties, but because no one understands him like I do, I didn't know that understanding meant allowing my body to be free therapy, allowing myself to be medication for a boy that faked his condition set 16. At 16, I felt myself hardened. Maybe it was the work of time, or maybe I got tired of dirty hands doing what dirty minds told them to, breaking away from a friend who only wanted the benefits was the best thing I did that year. Starting to love my body was a close second. 17 is new to me. But I've decided that this year is the year that I refuse to let myself feel anything but beautiful. I refuse to let myself think that a boy is what makes me worth something. 17 is the year I let myself feel like I'm worth something. This year, I'm truly a woman.
Do it. Brave New Voices family, let's all take a deep breath together. Inhale. Exhale. I do not know you. And it's a tremendous honor and also responsibility to be meeting you in this way. Your courage is phenomenal. Your assertion is inspirational. Your vow and your understanding is honest and true. Thank you. I'll say two very quick things. One, we have an embodied, collective, communal, almost sacred tradition at Brave New Voices. When we are so fortunate to be gathered, we hold a hand up. We get the poets back. And I invite you in these charged moments to just lift your hand up like an alleluia and get your fellow poets back. Second, something that is very necessary and I'm very proud of at Brave New Voices is that if you go into the chat and click on a link, there are professionals that are here to guide, to therapize, to hold, and to secure. This is a family, which means it's complicated, but we love and hold each other as such. Thank you, poet. Go in. Sid.
Thank you so much. What's happening? Thank you for that, poet from Fayetteville. In terms of these scores, we have an 8.5, a 9, a 9.2, a 9.6, and we got ourselves another 10, which is awesome, but nowhere near as awesome as that poet. Thank you so much for that bravery.
Yeah. Really exceptional work on top of everything else. We are going to continue. That is why we are here, to share and to be brave. All right. So, St. Louis, you are on deck. We are going to slide to the fresh coast, y'all. Please give it up for the poet from Los Angeles.
I tried to be cool with you niggas. You thought I was playing. I thought you knew better. You gonna have to kill me to stop me, because honestly, I can keep going forever. You measure a man by the lights on the ground, but how do he move under pressure? The difference between choosing and beggars.
We have a live poem from Christina Miles.
This is how I breathe. One, I've begun to teach myself Hebrew. There are 5 letters I know. I clatter them in my soft palate when I forget what English means. They are Alif, Beit, Vais, Gimel, and Dalet. There's a lot of pain in these characters. I learn them as a memorial to a people I've just gotten to hold in my tongue for the first time. I wonder, how much blood a language can hold before it rips at its seams, and how much it must bleed until the ones with the sewing needle are full. Two, I went to Germany once. We went to Dachau. It's the first of the Nazi concentration camps. At first, it's not means of extermination, just torture. The gates mutilate the German tongue with wrought iron and steel. Arbeit macht frei. Work will set you free. 2 years ago, the gates were stolen and a memorial of hunger was left with its maw open. By the time my Nike shoes scuff the dust floor of the barracks, the teeth are back to close me in. When I was 10, my mother made me watch a documentary on the last generation of survivors. There was a scene when the camera panned through a catacomb of shower heads and silver gas fell, and you know the story. I refused to shower for 2 days. For a month, I will only lay in the bath and stare at the sunflower-faced shower heads and wait for steam to become deadly. Now, I stand in a gas chamber and my only thought is to pray. Three, almost 9:15. They say it takes three generations for an ethnic enclave to fully assimilate to its new body. This is not true for those without a body in the first place. My father's great aunt is from Ukraine. She travels to America before the glass begins to shatter. My great aunt lives in Santa Monica and gifts me a drum set for my first Hanukkah and teaches me to shout Oy Vey when my sister steals the sticks. Jewish ancestry is matrilineal. My mother's great aunt was a Black woman from Texas. According to God's clause, I am not worthy of my own body. I will plant them on their land, and never again shall they be uprooted out of the land that I have given them, says the Lord, your God. For I've begun to teach myself Hebrew. Have you ever prayed in a language never meant for you to speak? I carry English with reluctance. It harpoons my molars and I get caught in the crossfire. English is a dead language in my mouth. Hebrew is full of thorns. They prick my tongue and draw blood. I learn to wade through it. I cannot pray in my own language, but here is what I know. Abba, Father, Shira la Adonai ki goai gaya. I will sing for the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. A rough translation. Father, I will formulate my own prayers from gum dialogue, retrain my tongue to forget the whip, lash only in worship. Father, I won't stop singing until I have returned home to you.
Listen, fam, somebody out here writing, somebody out here talk about Hebrew is a language full of thorns. They prick my tongue. I bleed through it. Somebody out here got bars, yo. Somebody out here writing. My Lord, let's go, young writer. Let's go. My goodness. Listen, man, we have Los Angeles. That was the second poet in this round. So we only got six poems left. We only have six poems left. And for those of you who have been at Brave New Voices, man, you know what it is. You know what it is. You've been here before. For those of you that are here the first time, participated all week, you know what it is. This is great literature. This is the precipice of the legendary. You know what I mean? And thank you, poet, for stepping into that legacy, and all you poets for creating a legacy of your own. Say, what we got over here?
Real quick. For that last poet from LA, we have from low to high, a 9.1.
Yes, let's go.
A 9.7.
Oh, word?
A 9.8. You see me looking at the screen making
sure. Oh, what? What?
A 9.8, a what? 10, and a 10.
Come on. All right, we got to keep going.
It's going. We got to.
I really want to stop because I'm really, really, really feeling your headpiece right now. And thank I kind of want to stop. You. Yeah, man, I'm really feeling that. I feel like, damn. Okay, but we can't stop. We can't stop. So can't listen, stop. Miami Gardens, y'all are on deck. Judges, thank you for getting that shit right. Miami Gardens, y'all are on deck. St. Louis, let's step to the screen. Let's step to the stage. Let's step to the mic. Let's go. Man a half humble, man a hey. Fling a rag a rhythm like it's so free. Bossy,
house on the post G. My money so long, it doesn't know me. It's looking at bringing a pre-recorded poem, Contrapuntal. Yo, Idris, tell them what they're gonna take the. When Steffi step out, do that turn up in a dish. Body comfortable, I'm physically fit. I'm a brown and sweet, just like the chocolate. Yo, Wiley, them ones sound like me. They're done a pretty, pretty with the upper body. Shut down in the city with me, bad girl. Every man want a piece of me. The back of them, my papa, them, my bun. Man want wine behind me, me have to move kind dusty. I'm looking for a better. I only wear makeup in the night. Beat my face to the reflection of the moon in the mirror. Allow her blue light's overflow. I bathe in her glory. Only she understands this beauty. Says these looks come at a cost, but knows it pays to look this gorgeous. Knows the sun will do nothing but expose all this highlight. Knows it's not a fan of color. Does not want to see me shine. So until I can grasp my beauty, she will appreciate me. Her presence I do not deserve. Her presence received only in the solitude of these walls. My shadows trace my eyelids. My femme, only a gift served in the dark. I am left only with myself in the mirror. I watch my shape. It spoons and waves under all my beauty. A body left in fear of the sun, how he reveals and destroys. I have never been one to hide my masculinity. Taught to walk with anger in hand like my father used to. Known for his ability to create pain and show it off like a trophy. He said to release it on anyone who tested my manhood. Friend or foe, said do not hesitate to spill when challenged. Make them run away, blood dripping from the scars. This is how you will heal your wounds. Crying is weakness. Weakness is for those who choose to die in vain. Stand tall. You are a man. Let this rage burn hot within you. You are not a man without it. Walk with these flames burning at your feet. You are not a man without them. Do not test the power of a son, of what the father can teach it, of what manhood can do to a boy, how it soaks all traces of the night, leaves only my shadow. I only wear makeup to hide my masculinity. Do not want to see my father in the mirror. He is the sun. Known for his rage to burn hot. I, a trophy he does not deserve. I beat my face like my father used to in the night. I bathe away blood dripping from the scars. He says these looks test my manhood, but I have never been this gorgeous. Says to release it, for he does not understand this beauty. Crying will do nothing but expose all this highlight. So I stand tall, walk with the moon, because to walk with anger is to die in vain. Allow her blue light to hide my masculinity, for I am a man without it. My femme soaks all traces of the night, crying until I grasp on my beauty. I watch the power of the sun, it spoons and waves my shadows, what manhood reveals and destroys, how it soaks the solitude of these walls. Do not test the power of all my beauty. This is how you will heal your wounds. A body left, this rage burning hot within, my beauty dripping from the scars. We'll be right back.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Let's go. Okay, first of all, hella sophisticated, hella fancy. Y'all got forms. You feel me? You got forms, you know? But fuck classic, y'all are on that future classic. You know what I mean? And then just the poem. The form is just the container, as the poem revealed, right? You transcend the container, whether it's words or gender. You know what I mean? Who needs boxes? And yet you use the boxes to your advantage to break your boxes. It's hella meta. Come on, family. Come on, St. Louis. Super proud. Super proud. Exceptional, exceptional. I would have been impressed if you just did the form. But then you killed it. So my heart has expanded. Thank you so much for that brilliance, for that excellence, and again, for taking the classic into the future. Sid, what say the judges?
Judges say, from low to high, we have an 8.9. We have a 9. We have a 9.4. We have a 9.5 and a 9.8. Give it up for St. Louis, y'all.
Okay, all right, St. Louis. All right, man, we're about to close the third round of the slam. This is pretty exceptional. Y'all, I want you please to join me in welcoming to the screen. Yo, this is Miami Garden. Step into the microphone. Let's go, M.I.A. Let's go.
It's easier than holding you down, can't be any harder than holding you up now. To come clean, I said, to be witness, to be witness. Finally, truth they say about me. Finally, came from my inner circle. It usually come from your inner circle or lack thereof, and I don't know. I can trust. I've been dropping out and I've been hanging out with my high friends, and we threw stone to pay attention. I mean, really, it's same me.
For some girls, love is a church, a sanctuary of safe space in between his arms. For some girls, love is a home, a heart beating and wait to save her from a heartless world. For some girls, love is paradise, heaven away from hell. For some girls, love is a blessing, the man she constantly asks for when she's on her knees, the one she'll say yes to when he gets on one knee. Not every girl is this lucky. A wise man once said, love is the perfect prison. We know a couple prisoners, women who fall in love with monsters masquerading as men, their affection making them stubborn. You know the kind, cheaters, beaters, mistreaters, boys who refuse to be kind, yet love to play games, forcing them to become prisoners of pain. These girls can't jailbreak out of heartbreak because they don't have the keys to their own hearts. It pains Adam down to his atoms as he watches Eve play around with snakes. Everyone warns her to stay away from the forbidden fruit. She doesn't listen, poisoning herself with bad apples, becoming yet another girl who allows bloodthirsty boys to plant bad seeds in her gardens, her temple sanded, our hearts, our pierced by pains of pain, as he watched beautiful girls, works of art only God can draw. Attach himself to boys who tell lies to get inside those drawers. You're stuck to his notion, you'll be nothing without me. You look to him as if he is Martin, but he's not looking to have you as Gina. This prison is a perfect one, and it pinch with fortunes of comfortability. A jail with Francis officers, keeping others trapped with lies such as, girl, he loves you, he's so sweet. All the other girls want him, which ain't nothing but lying lies that lies into her. Being manipulated in the backcourt and escorted down a path where they missed a shot at the look that they aimed for. They begin to regret picking a fruit that has an appealing look yet horrible aftertaste. They use their in-denial judgment for a reason to still care, keeping us good when shame-faced. Girls, ladies, women, never notice a good thing till it's gone. Good guys finish last, toxic ones finish first. Females need to break loose of this chain of inconsiderate men when the good ones are standing right in front of them. We are tired of being indicted of a crime only half of us committed. We are tired of watching women waste their time with the wrong ones. We are tired of seeing women getting locked up without the keys to their hearts. They are guys who turn your living hell back into heaven. Dudes like us had a cure to the poison you've been consuming this whole time. We're men who will make your house a home again. Stop acting far-sighted and see what's right in front of you. We're here.
Yeah. down, decibels. Let that ride out. Beautiful, beautiful, yes. Let's go, Dion Decibels. Responding beautifully to that beautiful poem out of Miami Gardens. Shout out Miami Gardens, shout out Florida. That's where my moms and pops are right now. You know what I mean? Shout out to South Florida. We need you. We need that energy to radiate. We need you in 2020, and we need progressive attitudes like that, family. Beautiful work. Incredibly impressive. Y'all, I can't believe that we 75% of the way through. And all throughout, been hearing and feeling and loving how we get down out in this piece. One more time from Miami Gardens. Sydney, yes. What's up, friend?
From low to high on that poem, we got a 6.
Oof.
We got a 7.8. We got a 9. We got a 9. We got a 9.1.
Okay.
Give it up for the poets from Miami,
Give it up for the poets from Miami. Y'all, we're going to fly through these scores. We felt what we felt. Listen, man, before we go into the fourth round, just want to bring up a special guest. I happen to know these random ass fellas that I met in the Bay Area, I don't know, last century. It's been a long time, but hella random, but they just decided to drop by. So I guess representing the Bay Area, these two random look at this. What's up, Rafael Casal? What's going on, BNV alum? What's up, Bay Area's finest? What's good?
Oh man, I'm just hanging here, trying to match my aesthetic to yours right here. You see this? I got my candles. I got a little hot pepper because it's getting a little. You know, some people are bringing the fire, so I had to bring a little hot pepper into this. You know what I'm talking about?
Keep it floral.
Come on, man. I think I overdid it. I'm probably gonna move a few things, but you know, my ambiance had to be right.
You know how that
what's
goes.
What's up, everybody? What's going on, everybody? The folks asked me to come by and just say what's up before we're getting out of this last round. I just wanted to point out a few things before we're out of here, because we've been watching and loving everything I'm hearing, and like, you know, my artistic beginnings were at Brave New Voices. Obviously, you know, in the last few years, me and my main collaborator, Davy Diggs, did this movie called Blindspotting that's just conveniently right there over my shoulder. And I always, when I think about that, I always think about like, it was a video from the Brave New Voices tour that some producers saw that made that happen. And from there came 10 plus years of me and David's work together. And off of that being theater and spoken word and music and touring, and so much community was birthed out of that, right? And in that time, you start to realize that this network of Brave New Voices, all of these people here, become your artistic family over time. And the thing that I remember least about Brave New Voices is scores and the slam. And the thing I remember most are all the people that I've stayed connected with and have become my artistic peers and mentors and mentees. I mean, Sid, who's been popping on here every other poem to read the scores, was one of my students at First Wave. I met Sid when she was 17. Marc Bamuthi Joseph, who I was just talking to, was my mentor when I was 14 at my high school. And so much of this is about the lineage of the arts. And in a time like now, where we're all in our different places and a bit disconnected in terms of like physical proximity, our through line with each other, young, old, whatever, is the fact that we're multi-hyphenate artists, that we're writers, performers, poets, playwrights, authors, like, and the poetry world is such a gateway art form into all of these things, which now looking back, we can see the tentacles of writing a 90-minute movie called Blindspotting about Oakland can be perfectly traced back to what the prompt was, which is how do we make a poem into a film. And so for the folks who've seen it, that's all sort of stemming from this muscle that you're working right now about finding a way to have your duty as a poet to be the people who make truth palatable. We are merchants of empathy. That's our gig. And so all of the collaboration becomes essential, and there has to be a lot of egolessness in that process.
Yo, what's that?
Oh, it's David Diggs.
What's that, man? I was on my Pilates.
I'm just in the middle of something right now, if you don't.
I'll just come in.
Oh, don't. He's coming in, everyone.
What's happening? What are we doing?
Hey.
What's this?
This is Diggs. I'm just talking to the brave new voices.
This is brave new voices.
Yeah. Well, I'm watching. Well, we're.
Who's up?
Well, I'm inspiring them right now with my words of wisdom.
You're talking. We're. Yeah, this is live.
We're sort of brave older voices.
We are.
I don't know how brave we are.
This is just
probably compromised.
Resigned ancient voices.
Yeah. But I'm just. I was having this moment. So do you mind?
Did they ask you to speak?
Yeah,
they asked you, but didn't ask me to.
Yeah, well, they technically asked us both, but you're so busy. So I just figured I'd handle this one on my own.
I love it when my white friend speaks for me. That's great.
All right, I'm throwing away my shell.
What's up, everybody? We've been listening. Before we decided to do this bit that references Blossom, a show which none of y'all have seen, we were watching everybody, and I'm as usual blown away and thankful and just in awe and reminded, like Rafa was saying, of like what it is really about. You all, this skill that you are cultivating of making the truth so beautiful that they have to hear it, that I have to hear it, is the most useful skill you will ever learn. And I think in your journey as artists or whatever you end up becoming, you're gonna be writing the words, you are going to be creating the language that shows us all how to get through moments like this, right? Moments that are unprecedented. You are creating the rule book for that. And we thank you. It has been an honor to sit here and listen to y'all spit for the past couple of hours, and just I'm blown away, and I can't wait to hear the next round. And just love y'all. BMV, this family that you are with right now, this is it. This is the family you will be with for the foreseeable. We have been working together for a very long time.
It's like 20 years. Like you find your artistic collaborators and peers and friends and family, and you're going to rock with them for a long time. So when you are watching everyone perform, the people that really speak to a truth in you, make sure that you're connecting with those people and that you're holding on to them over time. Because it really isn't, you know, this long journey of a million people that you're going to collaborate with. It's the people closest to you. It's your friends that believe in your work and that you believe in theirs. And so we're just so excited to see all the work that's being done here. We hope that y'all come to the Bars Workshop at some point. We run this program called Bars at the Public Theater in New York. We're going to keep doing that. And we're investigating like a digital space kind of like this. So we're getting our inspiration for that from this too. Mm-hmm. But it's a place for people to focus on how to take poetry and turn it into longer form work. And we really, really hope a bunch of you take us up on the offer to come and work with us. So
it's essentially just continuing the thing Bamuthi instilled in both of us.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
The tradition just keeps going.
We're just biting.
We're just biting.
At the end of the day. That's all we
do. I stole that line.
Yeah. Much love, y'all. We're so happy to be here. You know, do the thing. We're so happy to meet all these new people, a part of the artistic family.
Also, y'all are some barred up ass poets.
Yeah, y'all got some fucking like, bars out here, man. I don't know. Dude. Cheers to that fire. You feel me? Cheers.
Y'all, these are my friends, my brothers, my mentors, Rafael Casal, Davi Diggs. Davi, somebody said drop your hair care routine in the chat.
Water,
I'm feeling that. just gotta say three things real quick. One, I guarantee you that these two brothers are in each other's germ pod So don't trip on the lack of social distancing. They are
we've been within. COVID tested. We've been,
yes,
we get tested
we're
every week. We're good. And we
yeah, exactly.
We had a pause.
Exactly.
So
boom. Two.
You saw I had my mask outside. You know.
I saw that. I saw that.
I got my mask, y'all. Don't
there you
play.
Go. There you go. There you go. Two. Blossom. Come on, y'all.
What about that Blossom reference? What you know about that? What, an early 90s, late 80s reference?
Nothing is more appropriate for a youth poetry fan than a reference
God.
That is 20 years older than they are.
See, y'all went Blossom. I went Martin. I went like bruh man, flow.
Okay. Yeah,
but
yeah.
Yes. Same.
Okay. That was definitely a bruh man.
Three.
Same era. We were a little younger.
Three. Merchants of Empathy. Bars. Thank you, Raphael, for that. And four, I love y'all. I really do.
Love
thank you. Thank you for dropping in. Thank you for, you know, for your example, for your love, for your embodied creativity. Thank you for literally setting the bar. We have one more round of this slam. Seeing you on screen just makes me realize how much I miss y'all. You know, these are... these aren't just great artists. These are responsible, accountable, dignified individuals who ain't never forgot. So thank you for giving back.
And thank you for teaching me everything.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
What are you doing right now, bro? What door are you opening?
All right, man. Flowers, candles, Raphael Casal, Davi Diggs.
Peppers, bro. Fire.
Listen, bro. Come on, man. You know, since Second Sundays, you know, flowers and candles, man. I'm that guy.
Whoa.
Talk about bringing it back. Okay, we got to keep going. We got to keep going because this Love Fest could last forever.
Go.
All right. Go check out Blind Spotting at a minimum, y'all. But check out all the incredible projects that they got going on. You literally can see either one of these men on every single channel there is. Raph, I see the shot on HBO. Check it out. Snowpiercer is everything. Come on, man. I'm there. I'm shouting all y'all out. But we have one more round of the slam. So gotta love
Let's
you.
Go.
Let's go.
Keep Let's going. Go.
All right. So family. So BNV family. That is your BNV alum. Yeah, I mean that's representing super hard.
Mamuthi, real quick.
Tell me, Sid.
Got a little surprise. So we just jumping with surprises, right?
Oh, there's more.
That's how we do. There's a tad bit more. So much love to David and Rafa. That was my mentor back in college. So much love. But there's a person that we really, really want to honor, and we couldn't let them know because then they would have cut themselves out of the show. So their most amazing executive producer of anything, point blank, yes. Period, the
point
woman
blank
behind
period.
The camera, behind the mic, behind the mask, the most selfless human that I've come in contact with, the person who held us down as we tried to dream up a virtual festival, y'all. The person who told us every idea, yes, you can make that happen. Yes, the youth deserve that. Yes, you deserve to make that happen. Yes, you can cultivate space in that way. She never knocked us. She only supported us. I literally might cry if I continue. So please pan over to Darius.
We want y'all to give all of your love and all of your energy to the incomparable, amazing, and loving Miss Joni Asafo. Thank you
Listen,
for making
man.
This possible. Thanks for coming, Joni. Thanks for making this possible. We love you so
Joan
much.
Osato, man.
Y'all make some noise for Joni!
Listen. You want to talk about day one. Let's go. Let's go.
We're gonna leave because we got a show, but we had to make sure that we gave some honor to our Joni.
Listen,
Joni
man,
is
I'm
fearless, hardworking, everything. Goddess.
Listen,
thank you.
Listen, goddess for real. And honestly, the spine of this whole shit.
Yeah.
Like it does. Yeah. We do not stand. We could not walk. We actually could not do any of this. Really, for the last 20 some odd years, I've known Miss Joan. I interviewed Joan Osato. I did. That's how far we go back. You know what I mean? At the very, very beginning. And I can tell you that the last 20 years of Life is Living, of You Speaks, of Brave New Voices, just not possible without Joan Osado. So yeah, man, give homegirl her flowers because she deserves them. Queen Joni, thank you, thank you, thank you. Listen, so you want to have four more poets or what? We gonna keep going? You have any more surprises? Is Moses here? Is Jesus here? You know what I'm saying? Anybody else? All right, cool. We're going to keep going. Wow. Final round. Judges, I hope y'all are still awake. I hope y'all are uplifted as I am uplifted. Take a shot of water. The last round goes like this. Los Angeles will be kicking it off. St. Louis will be following Los Angeles. Miami Gardens after St. Louis, and closing the slam will be Fayetteville. So Fayetteville last, Miami Gardens third. St. Louis, you're on deck right now. We're gonna get out the way and do some more poetry, all right? Starting with representation from Los Angeles, California. Let's go, BNV. Not ready. Woo!
A live poem from Salome.
This is how I breathe. My Nigerian mother says, Galapa, Salome, go to bed. Fear burrows in the octave low tremolos of her voice, so I obey. Cocoon myself away and lay brainless on my back. A tradition that goes back farther than counting sheep, those white cotton clouds in those fields. A ritual receding farther than hairlines and cracking whips. So I reminisce. I let nighttime mist whisper through windows, making lava of my floorboards in the form of sleep paralysis, but I will not sleep. I will stay fixed on my clenched fists, nails carve hieroglyphs into my palms, and I squeeze a little harder to make sure I still exist, but I will not sleep. I have dreams that a white cop let his gun cock, turned a young black boy from a humble block to an ink blot, and I must be a prophet because my dreams keep coming true. You see the bags under my eyes and hand me concealer to disguise it. You expect a prize for having one black friend, while for us black girls, making that walk home in a little black dress at around 10 is an accomplishment. We don't sleep because we're scared of death. You don't sleep, and our men don't live past the age of 40 for the same reason, because you are afraid of the dark. Please do not compare your sleep deprivation to mine. You are sleepy and I am 3/5 alive. Igberam Dinala, I pray to God I don't close my eyes. I wouldn't survive the shadows I'd see. Why do you persecute me for laying dormant as the monster under your bed when I'm the one with lungs being crushed under your weight? Your bed built on the broken backs of African empires. Just wait till little Miss Nigeria becomes a big girl and the boogeyman don't scare her. Don't blink, gunshot, blood links, lung shrink. I clench my fists and feel nothing. My tears, crystal constellations on my cheek and my bed, now a pool of sweat. Mama didn't know when she came to America that African-American and Nigerian blood is the same sweet nectar nicotine for demons. I'm trained by my mother to fight these same demons by clenching my fists until the buildup of scar tissue allows me to feel nothing. You have taught us cocoons to fight demons by counting sheep. I'd be so glad when the sun goes down. I ain't all that sleepy, but I wanna lie down. Yes, drop your corner, lad. You ain't got your own mind. Yes, drop your corner, lad. You ain't got your own mind.
Beautiful, fam. Beautiful work. Woo! Y'all, listen, man, final round, we not here to play. What grace, what power, what intensity of emotion. You know what I mean? This is truly exceptional, fam. I will admit to you that it's been a little bit of a minute. I mean, it's been a little bit of a minute for all of us, really. We've been apart from one another. I personally have felt just a little disconnected from my poetry family as I moved my body across the country to take on a new gig. I am so happy. I feel so privileged to be reconnecting in this way, to have any doubt erased by the power of this moment and the beauty of your voices. It's an honor. It's an honor. Sydney, what say the judges?
What's up, what's up, what's up? I'm actually still waiting on one score, so
oh, yeah.
If you are that judge, no, no, no worries. I love being able to call somebody out. Hey, girl. Nah, I'm just being petty. But I loved everything you just said about that poet. They really are coming with the conversations, and I live for a narrative. And so thank you so much for that, LA. That poem truly touched me.
Hmm. Yeah, it's coming through.
Through, I think so. But in the meantime, I do want to shout out some of our sponsors. Yo, we had an amazing week. But just to name a few, we collaborated with the Smithsonian. Thank y'all for coming through for us, for Light Switch, for sending such amazing kits to all of our teams, the Library of Congress, Kennedy Center. You can see them all up there. Words Beats Live, Intersection for the Arts, for this amazing space. Oh My and First Wave. Art Change Us. We could not have put together a virtual festival without you. Shout out to staff. Shout out to everyone, everyone, everyone. And for that poet, from a low to high, we have an 8.
Oh.
We have an 8.2.
Ooh.
We have an 8.4. We have an 8.9 and an 8.9. But give it up for the poet. The
All right. Poet. We're going to have to give it up for the poet. Because I tell you what, no matter how many times I've been around this thing, you know, numbers up and down. But what Raphael said earlier is the thing. 20 years later, or however many years later, the thing that he remembers least is the scores. What he remembers is the camaraderie and the skill. So shout out to the poet. Miami Gardens. You're on deck right now, Brave New Voices, as we close out this final round. Please welcome to the screen, to the microphone, to the stage, the poet representing St. Louis, Missouri. Let's go, St. Louis.
She filled my mind up with ideas. I'm the highest in the room. Hope I make it out of here. She saw my eyes, she know I'm gone.
This is how I breathe. Screen check 1, 2. Before every action, Muslims say a prayer to send away our worst enemy, Shaitan, the devil. Bismillahi Rahmani Rahim, Maliki Yomadin, Ayaka Nabdu, Ayaka Nastain, Ehidina Saratul Mustakim, Saratul Azina and Amta Alayhim, Ghayal Madobe, Alayhim Waladwalin, Amin. When brown lives were traded at the cost of white greed, Shaitan was found. When partition divided Pakistan and India, Shaitan arose from the lips of each white man. Partition was not a war. It was history that has been replayed since the foundations of the earth, a war fought for the king's teeth. My people's land has always been seen before their life, mangled bodies, fertilizer for white gold, the separation of a country from itself, the separation of a body from itself, division by the hands of white historians, division by the knife that cuts the onions, the war that took my grandfather's eyesight, left him with war-soaked memories of Amma, Abba, Bai. He attended a funeral of silent lullabies for all the mangled bodies, left the survivors with jaws hinged, cold, and bloody, left my grandmother Salin tasting of iron, her fingertips eternally scabbed and holy, a woman who created earth from her own skin, her blood, bred with broken bones and exit wounds, bodies only left with memory, bodies only left with the last of what they took from us, bodies left with an image of Shaitan. Blue-eyed in porcelain, we remember our history and do not forget where the iron seeps from. My people wake in prayer. We pray for the blood. We pray for deserving. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. 2020, India and Pakistan fight together. A war against the colonizers. A war for all the silent funerals and mangled bodies. A war paid by life. In return for this body, for my daughter's body, and all the bodies after, we will make you remember. We won't let you forget. We will let Masala and Ajwan burn their way into your chest. Let it leave a stain of Pakistan and India. I will repeat the same lines, spit the same history. My language will cast spells you can't even comprehend. Before every action, Muslims say a prayer to send away our worst enemy, the colonizer. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Malik yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdina siratal mustaqim. Siratal ladzina an'amta 'alayhim ghayril maghdubi 'alayhim waladdallin. Amin.
Wow. Wow. Come on, yo. BMV, you know what it is. That's right. The stage is on fire. Wow. You know, we talk about poems as prayers. It's not a game. It's not a game. And the poem as prayer isn't some clever device. Poem as prayer is not like just a simile or whatever literary figure, man. It is the truth. Thank you for that bridge between the secular and the divine. Amazing work, Sydney. What's happening over there
for the poet from St. Louis? We have a 9. We have a 9.1. Mm-hmm. We have a 9.1. Mm-hmm. And then we got 2 tens.
Boom! There we go. All right, man. We got to keep it going. There it is. Hey, Fayetteville, you are on deck. Miami Gardens. Let's do this, BMV. Let's go, Miami.
Many boys of ebony essence are like closed chapter books containing stories glued to the tips of our tongues. Many of us are like broken televisions, unable to broadcast a picture
We communicate by fists, gang signs, tattoos, but never our words.
We pride ourselves
on silence and violence.
I ain't snitching is a phrase planted into our heads by our culture, choking on its own masculinity.
We rather shed blood than tears. Our minds, our haunted houses, holding in our fears. Amongst us, they hear to the pressure by our peers.
We are slaves to silence,
coping with drugs, women and money,
but never our stories.
But can you blame us? A king got the throne for having a dream.
Tupac got killed for trying to spark the mind
that would change the world. And Fred Hampton got honey like an animal because he was a Black Panther.
Can you blame color boys
for not using their voices when history has taught us that a Black man with something to say is far too dangerous to live?
How can you tell us to speak out when we witness our voices welcome violence?
Our words are one-way tickets to caskets. Take the mind,
keep the body,
we'll throw football
and shoot baskets. Keep it quiet,
Black boys stay silent
because it's dangerous to have melanin in the mouth.
Black boys stay silent
because history has taught us that a Black leader is a heat seeker.
Black boys stay silent because we don't want to make the targets our backs bigger, making it easier for them to pull the trigger. Should we not get another nick? It's not just us. A majority of minorities are minimized. We are warriors fighting a system without our greatest weapon.
Bottling up our war story because we're traumatized.
We suffer from our own form of PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder. We're losing these battles because we don't realize we're fighting a war.
Because we are satisfied
being silent, they profited off our bodies.
Brainwashed our minds.
Why should we let them take our voices?
We can rise up and raise volume,
accepting the risk of rebellion
to fight against the consequences. This poem is for the next generation of our gender
who have been muted. We can't subscribe to societal norms.
Time to use our voice boxes to break out of these boxes,
expressing our freedom to speak,
to be Black, bold and outspoken.
We go what lies in the dark to the light.
Continue to be the color boys,
speaking out for color boys.
Punch on the silence to survive.
Shout out Miami. Shout out Miami Gardens. Shout out that Miami Heat. And shout out my man, DJ Dion Decibels, for coming right there, coming right on time. You know what it is. Beautiful work, family. Beautiful work. Keep it going. Complicate the narrative. Complicate the narrative. That's what y'all are giving me right now, and I love it. Hey, Sydney.
What's going? Good? Thank you to those poets from Miami, from low to high. We got an 8.5. Mm-hmm. We got an 8.5. Mm. We got a 9.1, mm. a 9.5, and another 9.5. Give it up for those poets, though.
All right, all right, all right, all right, all right. Well done, fam. Yo, we about to hear from the last poets in the slam. They represent the state of North Carolina. More specifically, they represent the city of Fayetteville. Y'all, please give it up for the final poets of the slam representing Fayetteville, North Carolina.
I am not here to see the slave market house in Fayetteville burn. I am here to be the flame inside of it, crumbling your racist complex. And if there's going to be destruction of a structure, the people who protect it must go first. That call it history, that call it public property, while it only stands for certain people in private that can't read the room for racism in their buildings. For Black lives to really matter, we have to destroy the structure that doesn't allow them to. I am not here to see the system my life was built upon explode. I am here to be the bomb, drop down over your branches, your boroughs, your banks, your laws, your courts, your cabinets, your committees, your parties, your officers, your officers, your officers. If there's going to be destruction of a structure, it must go from top to bottom. The foundation cannot be left behind, or else whatever is built on top will have the same characteristics in the last and have the same faulty problems. Yes, there is no perfect structure. But at this point, America means deep racism in the dictionary. I am here to redefine. We need something like a blank space for a starting line to write in a watchtower that does not overlook sinking ships. So if there's going to be destruction of a structure, there will be little room for words. People have been calling, walking, and dying for justice. You cannot loot something you are owed. You owe us a new structure. I am not here to beg for it. I am here to collect.
Yo. Yo. All that audacity in it. All that audacity. I am here to be the bomb. Let's go. Let's go. Come on, Mozzie. You right. It's not a game. It's not a game. Listen, man. That's that intensity. You know you right. When you believe. When you're not hedging bets. When it's pure. When it comes from a genuine place. That's what you get. You get that fire. Thank you, family, for bringing that fire. Hey, Sid, what's happening?
Ooh, Fightville gave me the end of the slam right there.
Okay.
I came to collect.
Yup, yup.
For that poet from a low to high, we have an 8.9. Mm. We have a 9. Mm. We have a 9.3, a 9.4, and we're ending the night with a 10, y'all. All
right. That's the way to do it. That's the way to do it. Woo. Y'all, it has been exceptional. It has been exceptional. You know what happens, man. We have to do a little bit of housekeeping in order to make the housekeeping happen, though. We need to slide on over to at least one more voice, yeah. One that you've been hearing from all evening long. But, man, it is my sincere pleasure to ask you, my friend Sydney, you of the Floral Crown, if you wouldn't mind blessing us with a little piece as the evening slides to a close.
It would be my honor, Bamuthi. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, let's do it.
I would love to dedicate this to all the youth who participated in this slam. Truly, truly inspired me. And I just want to let you all know that in the face of this pandemic, in the face of all of this anti-Blackness and racism and all this hate, that you were truly a beautiful spot in my life, this whole planning session. So thank you. The poem I'm gonna share tonight is called Ode to My Big Belly, after Janae Johnson's Ode to My Ripped Pants. Oh, how my shirt stretched to her own healing, how my armholes exposed to match their own magnitude. Come, child. Let me tell you how I sit in chairs and burst open, how I spill over from the side like a blooming lilac or some other pretty thing that can't be kept. Tell me the part of your body that makes you feel most ugly, and I will tell you the story of a lie. I rub my belly in public for everyone who wishes I loved me less. My lover lays his head on my stomach like a promise to laugh. Tell me how my growth can be so wrong, how me loving the savory last suck off a chicken bone can be wrong. You ain't worried about my blood pressure or my caloric intake. You worried about if I press up against you, how I might just take you for what you're worth. And this is the second bra this summer, folding under the weight of it all. I'm not mad at you, girl. Move on to the next stage of your life. We can't all be Atlas, holding the earth on our shoulders, belly. Hear me good when I say you are the warmest home I've ever known. How you crease into myself heavy. You don't do nothing light, slight, ode to my thighs. How they kiss and suckle, rub and break, palatable even, but never faint. Ode to my stretch marks. Golden rods of iron over blood remind me of how much bigger I had to become to hold all of me. Belly, for the days when I am too full of myself and mad at the full of you, thank you today. Come, child, let me tell you of the ways you held me when I couldn't, how my ancestor mama had a big belly too. So belly, 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 today I'm all yours. Thank y'all. Thank y'all for giving me that space. Thank you. Thank you so much for the inspiration, Janae Johnson, wherever you are. I love you. And I'm going to keep it rolling because there's somebody who has been gracing your presence all night,
brave new voices popping in, holding space in so many different ways. Had a dope workshop earlier this week. I want to kick it over to hear a lovely piece from our MC of the evening, Mr. Marc Bamuthi Joseph. Make some noise. Go crazy in the chat.
Right on. Thank you. Shout out to Janae Johnson. And shout out to all of you. I probably don't like humans as much as I love the sounds they make. Specifically, melodic sounds. Cello and bow, slow and gripping. Tony Allen sounds. Lettucey casually humming to herself while listening to Billie Holiday. I like humans fine, but divine human music makes me vibrate. No ego or ownership, no ordinary love. The voice gives me no choice. My purest love is music. In the failing light of empire, the nation grieves alone. Their pastor has left them to pray over their dead while he's in the back rewriting the Bible. Alone, together, the nation grieves, mourns the recently departed and the norms of their past, living, mourning the death of normalcy. Sure would be great to have someone help us share this grief. Let it be said that in the time of the pandemic, music stepped up to be our one true leader. The one place where love and movement united humans, battles between music super producers, savage TikToks, concerts from the crib, stabilized the country's consciousness when it was beset by panic and viral uncertainty. Certainly that is love. I am grieving and I long to be led with love. These are sad times, yo. Folded over my own center without a prayer. Footsteps on warping wood overhead. I am cleanly rotting beneath. Desiccated windblown jasmine star in a cobweb, a corner of cedar, a flurry of skin and ash, a blue hunger. My sadness, a ladle unto the cloudless lake above me. In the economy of dis-ease, I've invested more in wiping my ass than cleansing my soul. I'll be eating these sheets for months, and all my leaders can offer me are gospel notes of amazing lack of grace and poorly composed critiques of the sun. Well, the sun is basically a welfare queen, just sits there untrustworthy, hides in the dark, can't even look him in the eye. If the sun ran for office in Florida, it'd be 48-47% in the polls, no lie. The enemy is unseen. The dead are everywhere, sorta. Like there are 140,000 dead and most of them people of color, but they're all out of focus behind the 200 white folks bearing arms and misspelled signs at the state house. Covert COVID, oligarchy undercover, the marriage of white supremacy, viral sickness and sadness. The quixotic charm of isolation has eroded. I've watched every single piece of content on Netflix and also read the same image of my bedside novel 19,000 times. I know every word on page 143 of The Water Dancer. What I could sure use now is an example of love from something other than music. A human touch of leadership from someone who considers how many of us are dying alone. Someone to gather us, pastor us, tell us that they've seen death, didn't see it as a vision, felt it as a lived permission, inception of an intuition of what we can all expect, a living lesson embedded in the processing genetics of all you touch. All you touch, you change. All that you change, changes you. You become the echo of the work, the echo of the impact, a signifier of your greatest teacher's mastery of craft. Encourage the living toward their larger purpose, born with lips to whisper, born to kiss the names of our teachers, back to the wind so their spirit might hear it and vibrate, a mitzvah incarnate and back again, reciprocal energy, spirit and flesh. In my sadness, I long for some guidance by an empath. Someone who says, don't worry, flock. At the moment of death, we are one with life transcendent. We are the dance divine, spreading like child laughter, blowing dandelion pollen into the spring light. We are the winter cool, released like children freed by the bell on the last day of school. Summertime magic, fool. In death, we are autumn enriched leaf, emanating transformation hues, freedom colored. We will never fall. We dance into the sky, a rope as thick as the way we lived our lives by our side, a rope thick as your life to help you climb. You become the light, you become the dance, you become the music you loved most on earth. Lord, where is the leader that brings us together like music? Says, don't worry, fam, this sucks, but I promise you are not alone. I got your back like your favorite honest love song.
There you have it, y'all. We had ourselves a slam. Thank you for
yes,
that.
Yes, we did. Yes, we did. Yes, we did. Yes, we did.
Yes. Thank you for that, Bamuthi.
Man. Yeah, no doubt.
Always a pleasure.
You know, figure. We doing poems.
We doing
I'll
poems.
I'll share one, too. Sid, it has been an honor, family, to be here with you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Dag. Shout out to Dion Decibels.
Shout out.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I shout out it. To all our judges.
Thank you.
Wow. Yes, much
thank
love,
you, thank
y'all.
You, thank you.
Much love. Sid, what we got, man? Take us home.
Right now, I'm actually going to ask you to announce it. It's in your text messages, but before that, I need everybody to drum roll in your own way, right? Whatever way you can, with your mouth, with your hands on your table. We can't necessarily hear you, but drum roll, please. It's not about the points, but we do want to congratulate folks for being in this space and doing a little silly competition. So, with no further ado, who won?
Listen, man, am I just announcing one or I'm going four through one? Am I being dramatic?
I like dramatic and I like four through one.
Okay, number four, Miami Gardens. Woo!
Let's go. I love y'all.
Number three, Fayetteville, North Carolina.
Okay.
Yes. Number two, Los Angeles, California, which means the 2020 champion of the 23rd annual Brave New Voices Youth Poetry Festival is the team from St. Louis, Missouri. Shout out. Go in. Congratulations. Much love to every single poet, not just on the final stage, but every single poet that competed to be part of your team. Thanks to all the teams. Thanks for all the coaches. Thanks for all the adults in the room. Thank you for all the mentors. And thank you, young people, for doing it. And man, especially congratulations to the young people from the Midwest, the young people from St. Louis. It was an honor to listen to all of y'all tonight and St. Louis this evening. The flowers are yours. Sid, any final words for us as we slide on out of here?
We do have some final words. We do. I've missed my partner in crime so much. So I'm going to let those final words come from the insatiable, ooh, legendary, ooh, yes, Halle Berry Derry.
Hey.
Oh, thank y'all so much for an amazing night of poetry. Shout out to St. Louis, bringing the crown back to the Midwest two back times in a row. Let's do it. Thank you so much, Bamuthi. Thank you to everybody who has joined us at home. Thank you so much to our amazing star-studded judges. I know y'all had a hard time attaching a point to a poem, but y'all didn't. Thank y'all so much. Y'all are amazing. Can we get cameras on? Poets to the stage. Every poet that was able to grace this stage, bring y'all up, turn y'all cameras on. We want to see y'all. We want to love on y'all. We want to honor y'all because y'all did the damn thing. And that's all what? Big period. Turn them cameras on.
Yes.
Amazing job, y'all. Amazing job. Thank y'all so much for sharing y'all stories. Thank y'all so much for holding space. Brave New Voices, we rocking. We'll see y'all at the Best of B&B tonight, as well as the virtual dance party. And we ain't done. The Indie Slam tomorrow on Instagram Live at Pretty Simple Cat. Cat with the K, where we gonna crown us an Indie Slam winner for Brave New Voices to close out our week. Thank you so much for an amazing virtual festival. Make sure y'all show love to all these poets that are on our screen. Hit the chat, give them love. Thank y'all so, so much. Dion, take us out.
Exceptional, y'all. Peace.
Thank you so much.
You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. They gon' tell the story was different with me. God's plan, God's plan. I hold back sometimes I won't, yeah. I feel good sometimes I don't, hey, no. I finesse down Western Road, hey, yes. Might go down to G-O-D, yeah, wait, yeah. I go hard on Southside G, yeah, wait, yeah. I make sure that Northside E, and still bad things, it's a lot of bad things.
Oh, they wish and 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 they